Take a look at all the action from Friday Night Football right here in North Central Ohio with great analysis, highlights, coach interviews, and so much more every single Friday night right here on the OH Report.
He's going to send a line drive down the field. It'll be fielded on the bounce. That is Schieffer. Schieffer finds a hole at the center. Schieffer turns on the burners. Schieffer could go. He's at the 50, 45. He's got one man to beat. Schieffer with the ball in his left hand. He's going to take it to the house. Wynford opens up the second half with a kick return touchdown. On WQEL and streaming live online on the OH Report. It is week one of the Burkhardt Farm Center Game of the Week on WQEL. Wynford hosting Galion tonight. And Jeff, we talked about the rain already, but let's talk about these two teams, both returning a lot of talent from last year. Galion especially, a defense anchored by a couple guys, Lincoln Tyrell
and Landon Campbell combining for almost 20 sacks last year, well over 150 tackles. They did lose Landon Kurtzman, but still two guys in the top tier of the MOAC defensive-wise. And that's going to be a tough going for the Wynford Royals, who struggled a little bit last year offensively, trying to run this wing tee under first-year head coach Kyle Skidmore. He's in his second year. These guys are a little bit more familiar with the offense, but still, that is a tough front to go against in the Galion Tigers.
No doubt about it. I think that, you know, for the Galion Tigers, they bring back an awful lot of talent this year, not only defensively, but offensively. I mean, these guys are, you know, for the type of schools that we see most of the time throughout the year, they are going to be playing both ways, or at least your highest level players are. And when you bring up those names, those are guys we're going to hear oftentimes, you know, that are going to come up over and over again. Galion just has a few bodies that they've got to replace kind of in the interior to match up with a lot of the skill players that they're bringing around on the outside. If they do that and they do it really well, they're going to be a tough beat this year, and it's going to be not easy. But if they struggle in those positions, it could be a difficult matchup, because we know from Kyle Skidmore last year, he likes to just pound that rock down at you. And if you don't have those interior guys who can maintain discipline, maintain their spots, and hold up strong, you could end up with some issues there, and maybe they start gashing you with yards with some of the returning backs that they have. So should be an interesting battle to see, you know, both these guys, like I said, bring guys back, but who's going to fill the holes that they did have from last year? Who fills them better and stronger?
Second year, you talk about Coach Skidmore's second year at the helm of this offense. He brings back Ashton Warren, returning starter, a guy who's got a big arm but struggled with his accuracy last year. He loses his main back in Cohen Keith, loses his main receiver in Sam Colleen, but he's got guys that are ready to step up. He's got James Rinfus on the outside. Yeah. He's got Anthony Evans, Caden Blair, two guys that got a lot of carries last year in that split backfield with Keith. So a lot of familiarity there in that offensive backfield. Do you look for Coach Skidmore to really just look to establish the line of scrimmage? He's got his younger brother to lead the front line. What do you expect in this type of climate?
I would be shocked if they do anything different than we saw last year. Maybe a little bit more in terms of creativity out of the offense, because I think that was the one thing that potentially hurt them, was that even though this is, you know, Coach Skidmore, he's got a certain way that he likes to play, kind of the old school. You know, it was, I think, early in the season in particular, moderately predictable. As the year went on, I think they started kind of finding themselves a little bit more. They played a lot of close games last year. I mean, they had a couple of blowouts, but those were against the highest level teams that they played.
Multiple one-score losses.
You know, but, I mean, yeah, so when they lost to, you know, Colonel Crawford or to Cary or whatever, those games were tough for them, but those games were tough for everyone. You know, I mean, those were the highest levels of the N10. Against everybody else, they were losing by, you know, Seneca East, who, you know, was third in the league, only beat them by a point. You know, so this Wynford team was sort of kind of trying to find their identity a year ago, and bringing back so many players, especially his younger brother, Kalen Skidmore, is an outstanding player, both sides of the ball, you know, on the line. Mm-hmm. You mentioned Anthony Evans coming out of the backfield, really strong back. I mean, you know, if they take all of these players and they kind of build upon what they did last year, I don't see any reason why Wynford doesn't make a seismic jump in, you know, from a 2-8 season to being, you know, potentially best case scenario, I mean, maybe even 8-2 if things really go their way. But they really need a lot of things to go their way. They need to have made those developments. They need these guys who came back to have improved, gotten stronger, gotten bigger, gotten faster, and also gotten more comfortable with this offense. And defense, you know, because again, it was totally new to him a year ago, and you could see it at times, especially early in the season.
Their work's cut out for them tonight. They're facing the Galion Tigers, who went 5-2 in the MOAC last year, 6-5 overall, and they're returning a ton on the offensive front. Yeah, certainly they lose Carson Frankhouse, but look at what they bring back. Gabe Ivey. Also, Braxton Prosser, Eliza Chafin, Cooper Kent, all guys that are playmakers on the outside.
Yeah.
But I say again, Gabe Ivey is what drives this Galion Tiger.
Well, Gabe Ivey was last year when we saw him early in the season, and it was kind of an interesting. We were looking at him going, he's a nice back, and you know, but it was a game in which Galion was having a hard time sort of kind of getting things going. But once they did, they realized they had a game breaker. Like, and, you know, by the time the season was over, he's running for 1,500 yards. He's going more than 7 yards a carry. And I don't see there's any reason why Galion gets away from being that team again. A year ago, the quarterback position was really kind of where they were in flux. They were constantly moving back and forth between Prosser and Cooper Kent.
A lot of Wildcats there.
Yes, you know, Prosser's a much better runner. Kent's a more stationary, but throws a little bit better ball. And I think they had a hard time figuring identity-wise what they wanted to be outside of Gabe Ivey. Now, it didn't hurt them that much when they got into the MOAC. They had a pretty darn good season in a very good league. But I have a feeling bringing back so many players and, you know, Coach Dick having a whole entire offseason to kind of look back at last year, he's got a good opportunity to look at it and say, this is where we were strong and this is where we were weaker. And let's improve upon that, because quite honestly, we bring almost everybody back except for some linemen that were valuable and really important. But skill-wise, I know exactly what I have and who we are and what we can be good at.
It's 75 and rain-soaked here at Wynford Stadium. It is week number one of the Burkhart Farm Center Game of the Week. We'll take a quick break and be right back for the kickoff between Wynford and Galion.
Are you ready for the comeback?
Take a look at all the action from Friday Night Football right here in North Central Ohio with great analysis, highlights, coach interviews, and so much more every single Friday night right here on the OH Report.
He's going to send a line drive down the field. It'll be fielded on the bounce. That is Schieffer. Schieffer finds a hole at the center. Schieffer turns on the burners. Schieffer could go. He's at the 50, 45. He's got one man to beat. Schieffer with the ball in his left hand. He's going to take it to the house. Wynford opens up the second half with a kick return touchdown.
Yeah, it's the comeback. Are you ready for the comeback?
Back on WQEL and the OH Report, Josh Stallings alongside Jeff Roberts tonight, getting set for the Wynford Royals and the Galion Tigers. Wynford won the toss. They deferred to the second half. Galion will receive the kickoff and head south. Back deep for the Tigers, Elijah Chafin, Gabe Ivey, Jacob Chambers. Already week number one of high school football here in North Central Ohio. Kick is up and is a short one fielded. No, he's off the chest and bounced back. Wynford had a shot at it, but I think Galion was able to recover. Short kick up the far sideline.
Yeah.
And the up man not ready for that. It is slick playing conditions. Galion able to recover. They will have it first and 10 from the 43. Yeah. Interesting start to the season.
Yeah, Lincoln Tyrell, he came underneath it, but sort of short. Like, I think he kind of got caught between him. Do I want to try to catch it with my body or with my hands? And it just bounced forward. They got lucky. He was able to reach out and jump on top of it, but it's going to end up being good field position for Galion, but not exactly the way Coach Dick wants to see them get good field position.
And here you have it. Braxton Prosser out. He's the head of the offense. He will go shotgun with a back to his right. Now they're going to shift. Two wide receivers to the right side. They go tight end and a wing left on first and 10. Handoff. Here's Ivy. First carry of the night, and he's going to get knocked down in the backfield. Great play made on that far side, collapsing that end. That's the linebacker, number two, and that's James Rinfus, the senior, coming in and making the play.
Good pursuit right there on the right side. Again, you know, for Galion, they like to kind of split things out wide, open it up so Ivy has a lot of running lanes to go through, but Wynford Royals front seven was tracking him very, very well on that play.
So now an I formation on second and 11. Prosser under center is going to spin, hand it off. Ivy left side this time. Going to dive down. Just a simple ISO play. Got three out of that one. So a little bit more of a manageable third down here with third and eight.
Yeah, Caden Blair cutting through, getting him around the ankle. Ivy able to fall forward, but still good job of pursuing into the backfield, getting off his block and being able to hit him. So minimal gain there, and it's going to put Galion in a scenario where at a third down where they're at, they're probably looking at throwing the football.
Blair doing a nice job on that play, collapsing. Didn't make the tackle, but beat his guy and able to slow up that ISO play. Here's third and seven. Prosser in the gun. He's got Ivy on his left hip. Lone receiver to the right side, one to the left. Ivy up the gut. Nice hole for Ivy. Ivy broke one, broke two, and he's got a first down on third and eight. And putting a lot of faith in Gabe Ivy, and Anthony Conchel told us before this game started, it was going to be Ivy.
Yeah.
And they're showing it here. Three straight to him. They're going to hurry up, go for it on first and ten. Back to him. Ivy goes left side, and a tackle. Yeah. There's a late flag. I was going to say, looked
there's
like he might have had a face mask or a horse collar.
His helmet was sitting on the ground after the play, which is generally a sign that that they don't fall off on their own very often. So probably got it right around the face mask there. Yep, sure did. So on the reach out, Kalen Skidmore making the tackle, but got his hand right on that face mask and brought him down. So probably will end up costing some yardage here against the Wynford Royals.
Skidmore, an absolute monster offensively and defensively for the Wynford Royals. One of the strongest kids, if not one of the strongest people you're gonna meet. You're going to have to double team and triple team him at times this season, but gets caught for the flag there.
First game of the season for the officials, too, is they're having some discussion over whether or not this should be a how many yards do we give them on this? So
skies have cleared a little bit. The rain has subsided.
Yeah, before we left, meteorologist Dan Messerschmidt said that the weather should get nice as we move on here a little bit. So there it is. So from the line of scrimmage, there's the 15 yards on top of it. And that's going to put them a little bit deeper into Wynford territory on the first drive for the Galion Tigers.
So the first penalty of the season on the Royals. And again, the Galion Tigers hustling to the line of scrimmage. Split wide receivers. Prosser fakes the handoff. He's going to scramble up the gut. Has a lead blocker. Hit, knocked down, but not after a gain of five. And a good carry there by Prosser. Five straight runs now. And Galion is just, making their way right down the field against this Wynford defense.
Yeah, Wynford came out and did a really nice job on the first couple of plays, but the nine-yard run by Ivy that got him the first down, and then you add the penalty after that, and now it feels like the Tigers have a lot of momentum.
Prosser again gives to Ivy, moving left side behind Frankhaus. Got a big lead blocker there in Carson Frankhaus, the 5'10", 190-pound senior. But Wynford got to him, knocked him down for a one-yard gain on the play.
Now, Coach Dick surprised me last time. They were in a third and nine. They ran the football, and that was in their own territory. Here, I see them in four-down territory, so I think they can easily run the football and decide to go for it on fourth down if they decide they want to.
Landon Prosser goes wide left. Elijah Chafin wide to the right. I formation, and they're going to get him off sides. Hard count. Neutral zone infraction against the Wynford Royals, and that's going to be a free first down. Second penalty of the night on Wynford, and that's two free first downs for Galion.
Yeah, that's not going to make coaching staff for the Wynford Royals very happy, as they've already given up now 23 yards here on this drive. Galion going to be tough enough to stop. They don't want to give them yardage like that.
Opening drive of this first game of the season. 9:02 in the first quarter. Galion working its way south on Wynford. Prosser going to hand off. Ivy trying to stretch it left side. Great play made behind the line of scrimmage. I believe that's James Rinfus coming up and making the hit.
Yep.
Ivy trying to use his speed to bounce it. Rinfus slammed the door. Brings up second and 11.
Yeah, not easy to make those type of open field tackles, but he went there on top of him, got a little help from Bryce Locker on a follow-up coming over from the defensive line. But out in the open field like that against a player like Ivy, it's easy to kind of get tentative, and Rinfus did not.
Prosser wants to sling it from the gun. Comes near side. He's got Chafin. Chafin trying to make a man miss. Can't do it. Dropped for a short loss on the play. Anthony Evans over there. Bryce Locker. Gang tackling on two straight plays for the Wynford Royals, and that's going to bring up a big third and 12.
The one thing I'm real impressed by Wynford early on is they are, you know, so far they're tackling quite well. I mean, they're on top of it. So they're coming, they're staying on top of things, and even if they can't get off the block, they're not getting pushed out of the way. So they're cutting down running lanes, and they're making the guys who have the ball run into the other defenders who are bringing them down. So good effort right now by the Royals defensively to get guys down to the ground. This is a tough offense to work against in the first game, so impressive.
Tight end right, lost the snap. Ball is loose, and Prosser able to cover it up. But bearing down on him was Bryce Locker, and that is a huge play on third down. It's going to bring up fourth and 20, and Galion will have it at the 30-yard line. I imagine they're going to go for it, unless they got somebody who can drill a 47-yarder.
It's a heck of a kick. You know, Prosser there, you know, he just took his eyes off the ball. It was kind of, you know, the ball's a little slick. You know, it was raining earlier, and it was on his hip, but he started to try to still run with it. Think he had a good handle on it. Did not, and, you know, coming up from the side. Great job by Locker. You know, one of the first things you tell people on defense is make a decision, live with your decision. You got to go for it. So, you know, he was kind of sitting there, sitting back a little bit, but when he saw the ball hit the ground, he took off when he noticed Prosser was struggling. He got in that backfield.
Galion Tigers going to take a timeout here, facing a 4th and 21 with 6:52 to go in the first quarter. You're listening to WQEL 92.7 FM and the OH Report. We'll be right back.
Hi, I'm Josh with Scout Construction, proud sponsor of local teams and athletes. Check out your favorite local sports right here on the OH Report.
Out of the break, two wide receivers to the left, two to the right. Prosser in the gun. He's got Gabe Ivey on his right hip. Wynford showing a four-man front. They bring three. Prosser sets up, steps up in the pocket, now wants to scramble, goes back left side, and he slips and falls down. Loss of one on the play, and Wynford will have it first and 10 from the 31. A three-man rush got to him and shut it down on fourth down.
Yeah, they were trying to go kind of deep slant to the middle of the field. I think that was the initial target. I think it was Chafin, you know, and that's where they were hoping to get him through. But Wynford just dropped everybody back and cut down all the lanes. So then it became Prosser, all right, like I'm going to try to run around and, you know, get some more time with my legs. But even that, they were on top of it. The linebackers who were sort of kind of watching him there, they didn't get fooled, and he ended up going down to the ground.
Senior quarterback Ashton Warren under center, and a give on the first play for the Royals. Caden Blair up the center. No gain on that one.
And again, you know, for Wynford, I even thought last year defensively they were normally pretty stout, and offensively they had their moments. It was just, you know, kind of touch and go at times. So we'll see how they come back out this year.
Royals running that wing tee. Dive play goes to Blair. He's got an opening this time. First down and more for Blair. Good block on the outside by Rinfus. It's up over the 45 and down at the 47.
Yep. And again, you know, for defenses, they don't see a lot of wing tee anymore. That used to be a...
Everybody wants to be flashy.
Everybody wanted to run it one time, and everybody said, nope, we're all going to the spread. And now it's sometimes tough to prepare for, you know, because you really don't have the type of practice players to be able to do it and to do it effectively.
Warren's going to sling it near side high of his intended receiver, yeah. James Rinfus. Just a quick bubble pass. It was Rinfus and Jake Stover lined up wide to the left. And Ashton Warren's first pass slips out of the hands. Yeah. It'll bring up second and 10.
Yeah, Warren was sort of floating away when he threw the ball. He didn't really set up and kind of step into the throw. He floated backwards, and that's the reason why the ball sailed on him. A little mechanical issue.
Tight formation on second and 10, 5:50 in the first quarter. Rinfus goes in motion behind, and he's going to hand to the up back. That is Blair. And Blair knocked down after a gain of two. A lot of bodies flying inside. And excuse me, that was actually James Rinfus on the carry.
Not accustomed to seeing Rinfus out of the backfield, but again,
not out of a three-point stance.
That's what I mean.
Sure.
Yeah, I mean, but new season, and remember, I mean, that was, you know, last year they had, you know, their three-headed backfield with Keith, Evans, and Blair. Well, Keith being the one that graduated, move Rinfus back there maybe to take his spot.
A little bit more speed.
Yep.
Here's Rinfus wind up wide to the left along with Stover. Warren under center on 3rd and 7. Ashton wants to throw. Rolling left. Pressure from the backside. Lets it fly. One-on-one coverage. And it was deflected out there by Gabe Ivy. Great job on an island. It was one-on-one. Ivy versus Rinfus. Ball a little bit behind James. And Ivy got a hand on it to knock it down. Brings up 4th and 7. Wynford forced to punt here from the 49.
Kind of a tough play if you're Ashton Warren. You know, it's beginning of the season, first game, guy's a little hyped up. His first throw, he kind of sailed a little bit because his mechanics were off. And here on that one, even though that's the long side of the field, you have him throwing on the run across his body into tight coverage. Not the easiest throw. I usually like to kind of make it a little easier on the first throw or two.
Blair with a rugby-style punt. Fair catch made by Elijah Chafin at the 26, and a late hit going to come in.
Yep,
that's
going
to be the third penalty on Wynford already.
Yep, sure enough. Aiden Schaefer, the senior, kind of coming in on him. And, you know, even though he put the arm up, called for the fair catch, he kind of just wrapped his arms around him. And, you know, I think the officials, maybe if he would have let go right away, they may have been like, hey, you got to be careful. But he just held on to him there and was like, okay, you made it obvious there. 15 yards right there, you know, just kind of a little mistake. And actually, as we're seeing it on the replay on the OH report, we realize what happened is Schaefer was looking back at the punt. He had beat his blocker, looked back at the punt, and he never saw the fair catch. Mm-hmm. So when he turned around, the arm wasn't still in the air. His eyes came off the ball came off the returner at that point in time.
4:56, second drive for the Galion Tigers. Here's Ivy, stretch play, left side, nice stiff arm. Ivy got the corner. Ivy's got a first down and driven out of bounds. Good stiff arm there on James Rinfus, trying to make a hit, and Gabe Ivy picks up about 13.
The thing that I thought Wynford was doing so well on the first drive, that time not as well, because it wasn't just a great stiff arm, but it was Wynford sort of lunged for him. They weren't moving their feet to try to get in front of him. They're trying to kind of get out and just reach, try to get a hold of Gabe Ivy, and he made him pay for it.
Landon Prosser splits wide to the left. Under center, and he mishandled the snap. He's got to dive for it and covers it up. It'll be a loss of 2.
Yeah, and
Braxton, once again, mishandled that snap, and it hurts him.
Yeah, because the previous play, Ivy, even though we thought he had a first down, they marked him out of bounds a yard short, so now they're looking at a 3rd down and 4.
Tight formation, 2 wide receivers, 1 on either side. Gabe Ivy on the dive play. Up close to a first down, he's going to be about a yard shy at the 49. And a lot of these run plays for Galion, all left side.
Yes. It's where they're seeing either their strength or Winford's weakness, either way. But
I'd run away from Skidmore.
Yeah, I was going to say, but Skidmore's been on that side, so
fourth
it's just kind of
where
they see their strengths. And right now they're setting up like they're going to punt. They're at the 50-yard line. This doesn't seem like a punting spot. I'd probably play conservatively if I'm Wynford.
They will punt it away. Blair stands at his 10. He's going to let it bounce and kind of dies inside the 10-yard line about the 6. And so Wynford going to have a long field in front of him. 3:40 to go, first quarter. Still no score between the Royals and the Galion Tigers.
Yeah, and we are excited that when the first score hits, we do have a new sponsor. The Chevy of Bucyrus, save more on Route 4, first to score. Whoever scores first for either Galion or Wynford here tonight will get themselves a $25 gift card to a local fast food restaurant and a shirt, courtesy of Chevrolet of Bucyrus. So excited about that new promotion that we have. And, again, could be either Galion or Wynford. Whoever can get some points on the board, they'll get themselves a gift certificate and a shirt tonight.
Both teams sticking to the old school play, running the football, wet conditions, nobody able to get.
There is a flag down here on the near side, kind of right in front of the Wynford sideline, almost like it's a sideline violation spot. But that official maybe just saw something different.
Warning.
Yeah, that would be just a warning.
Wouldn't
so.
this long of a conversation.
Right, so that's what leads me to believe that it might be something more. It wants a punt, so. Usually, when they're having these type of discussions, it's because they're trying to figure out, does the yardage come at the play, mm-hmm. or do they have to repunt? Because obviously, Winford's sitting at the 7-yard line where they marked that they would be happy to let Galion repunt this ball.
Of course, it is week one of high school football. Don't forget to call in for the special edition of the phone board tonight with Davey Jones. 419-562-2222. Toll free 1-888-843-0024. Davey, talking everything in the wide, wide world of sports. We got Buckeye football coming up. Browns Nation ready to go. Guardians baseball, they are just out of first place in the Central. And, of course, it is high school football. So, Davey Jones in a special edition of the Phone Board Show coming up tonight.
Penalty went against Wynford, and that is bad because it was enough to give Galion a first down. So they'll get the ball, and they'll get to reset some things here.
So a hold, I guess, during the play. We'll reset them back to the 49. Now they'll mark it off.
Yep, so there's a first down for Galion. Remember, they were only about a yard and a half short. That's the reason why I thought that Wynford, being at the 50-yard line, I thought that they should be conservative in the return. You don't want to go too heavy and give up easy yardage on a punt fake, because that's sort of like prime space to be able to do that, short yardage, middle of the field. But, you know, you give them a penalty, they'll just get the first down that way, and Galion keeps the drive alive.
Fourth penalty on Wynford tonight, and all have given them first downs, first and 10. Prosser under center. Here's Ivy. He's got a head of steam. Broken ankles into the secondary. Ivy up the sideline. Ivy one man to beat. Knocked down inside the 5-yard line. What a move by Gabe Ivy. Came through the line of scrimmage screaming. A little shake and bake to the second level. See you later.
Yeah, that's a big run right there. About 43 yards. Took it inside the 5-yard line again. Because the thing about Ivy is once he can kind of get through that first seam of guys, it's just going to become a foot race. And the only reason they got him is because Ashton Warren just had a good angle. He was coming from the middle of the field as a safety. But that's a big run right there.
Put Anthony Evans on skates. First and goal from the 4. Ivy deep in the eye. They go to him again. Ivy up the center. Ivy fights for it. Knocked down shy.
Probably got about halfway there.
Ball at the 1.5.
And again, Galion threatening the score and threatening to be the first to score. So again, we'll have that award for Chevy of Bucyrus.
Skidmore making the play there. Ivy again, deep in the eye. Prosser has it, goes to the fullback this time. And again, Wynford, front four making the play.
Yep, not quite there.
And they knock him down a half yard shy of the goal line.
Carson,
so it's going to bring up third and goal.
Yep, Carson Frankhouse just taking the direct right up the middle. Got about a yard on that one, so third down, probably about the 1-1.5 yard line here.
2:40 and counting, first quarter. Tigers will send one guy wide to the right. Prosser under center, I formation behind him. Has it, spins, gives to the fullback, fighting for it, and I think he's denied again, Jeff.
He is.
He is short of the line of scrimmage. The Wynford Royals doing their best to keep him out.
You know, he's getting like a half yard each time. He's so close, but he's getting forward, but not far enough. Now, like I said, he was probably about the 1 yard line before, maybe 1.5. Now he's at about a little inside the one. You know, getting about 3/4 of a yard, you know, maybe a half a yard at best. But a fourth down and 1, and see if Coach Dick wants to go to the same play call. He went straight up the middle with Frankhouse twice. Does he do it again, or does he just say, "All right, Prosser, tuck and move forward, give it to Ivy," or is he just going to call a timeout and talk it over and figure it out? That's what
and
it's going to be.
He will take his second time out of the first quarter. Stops the clock with 1:48 to go. Facing a 4th-and-1. So we will take a break as well. You're listening to WQEL 92.7 FM and streaming live on the OH Report. Are you ready for the comeback?
Hi, I'm Josh with Scout Construction, proud sponsor of local teams and athletes. Check out your favorite local sports right here on the OH Report.
QEL WQEL. Josh Stallings, Jeff Roberts with you for week number one of high school football here from Wynford. The rain has let, you know, it is passed on.
Yeah.
It seems to be like a pretty nice night. The wind's still blowing right around 15 to 18 miles an hour. Still a more of a run-friendly evening. And we'll see what Galion wants to do here on fourth and goal from the one-yard line. Heavy backfield. They got an I formation in front of Ivy. Prosser spins. Here's Gabe up the gut. Gabe is hit, and I think, they got it in. I thought Wynford had the goal line stand. Ivy was rocked at the goal line, but just enough momentum to get across. And Galion scores first.
And congratulations, Gabe Ivy, the winner of the Chevy of Bucyrus. Save more on Route 4. First to score. He's going to get himself a $25 gift card to a local fast food restaurant and a t-shirt as a result of that touchdown. Gabe Ivey, first points on the board for the Galion Tigers.
6:44 to go in the first and a little muddle huddle. Galion now will bring it together. On to attempt the extra point is 28, Alec Carver. And a flag flies. I think Galion's got too many guys. Yes.
Yep, sure do.
So the first flag against Galion tonight. Wynford already with four penalties in the first quarter. You'd think after a couple weeks of 2 days and preseason scrimmages and everything, you'd have that first field goal team ready to go. But they sent 12 out.
All right.
Carver. Back, snap is back, kick is up, and it hits the upright and ricochets through. It is good. So Carver makes it 7-0 here in the first quarter. Minute 44 to go. Galion up on Wynford, 7-0. We'll be back.
Hi, I'm Josh with Scout Construction. Proud sponsor of local teams and athletes.
I guess.
Check out your favorite local sports right here on the OH Report.
Is that what you guys want to do? Jeff, very run heavy.
Yeah.
It has been Gabe Ivy. We talked about it in the pregame, and they have done exactly that. And he's looking phenomenal midseason form here in the first quarter.
Well, quite honestly, I mean, even though Wynford was playing pretty well for a little bit, he cracks open a 42-yarder. You add in a couple of Wynford penalties, and then all of a sudden that's the difference. That's the difference of a 7-0 score. Because at this point in time, what we're seeing, I hate to say this, early on out of both teams is – a struggle to throw the football. I mean, neither team is impressed. And now, obviously, Wynford's only hit it once, but Ashton Warren's thrown two passes. They weren't, either one of them weren't real great. And Braxton Prosser's, you know, tried to throw once, basically got sacked, has one throw that was completed that went for negative 1 yard.
And those two fumbles, I think, then, both were pass
exactly,
plays.
Exactly. And then you got fumbles and things like that. So ultimately, you know, Ivy's ability to break open a run like that, that's the type of stuff that's going to make differences in games that are going to be ground oriented.
Blair and Evans back deep. Here's Anthony Evans from the six. Evans starts up the far side. Evans lowers his shoulder. He's hit and dropped at the 21-yard line. Not a lot of space there for Anthony Evans. So it'll be Wynford in their second possession of the evening. Minute 39 to go, first quarter. We will try and answer the Galion touchdown.
And I think for the Wynford Royals and for their fan base, you got to look at it. The first quarter is almost over. And they have not run a lot of offensive plays. They got the one really good 13-yard run by Blair, got him a first down. But other than that, they've been pretty much on defense this entire time. So they really kind of need a drive, sustain a little bit of a drive, help the defensive coordinators kind of get some time, put some things together, and think about how they might have to adjust to Gabe Ivy.
Going to go fullback. That's Evans getting the carry. Just a simple dive play at the wing tee. Not a lot of fancy work out of Wynford.
Nope.
You know what you're going to get. They're going to try and shove it down your throat. They got big guys up front, Kotalik, Skidmore.
Yeah.
They just have to establish that line of scrimmage.
But, you know, as windy as it is, between Kotalik on Wynford and Holden Hunter on Galion, that's like a wall. It's basically blocking off any type of conditions. They're both about 300 pounds running into each other.
Warren under center, end around play, looking for a block. Evans can't find it. Short gain on that one, maybe a yard.
Yep. Too many white jerseys over there being unaccounted for. And for Evans, that's, you know, doesn't really have any space to make any cuts on anything like that, because he's got Skidmore trying to kind of be his lead blocker, but, you know, he's got guys even coming from the backside. Landon Campbell for Galion coming in there from the backside making the tackle. But he's got the guys in front of him, guys behind him, so not getting a helmet on every defensive body.
Two guys split wide to the right. Galion showing blitz. A lot of guys in the box. Warren going to toss it right side, looking for it, and nowhere to go. I mean, nowhere to go on the toss play for Blair.
Yeah, actually lost a yard or so on that play. So, you know.
Or excuse me, that was Evans.
Evans, yeah. But either way, I mean, that could have been pretty much anybody. There was no way to go anywhere. There's about five white jerseys there. And it's part of it is, you know, I think Coach Dick is basically looking at Wynford saying, I'm going to dare you to throw the football.
Yeah.
I'm coming in tight. Whatever you can do. If you can beat me, fine. But I don't think you can.
That's going to take us to the end of the first quarter. At the end of one here from Wynford, it's the Galion Tigers 7 and the Royals 0. You're listening to High School Football in Week 1 on WQEL and the OH Report.
Are you ready for the comeback?
He's going to send a line drive down the field. It'll be fielded on the bounce. That is Schieffer. Schieffer finds a hole at the center. Schieffer turns on the burners. Schieffer could go. He's at the 50, 45. He's got one man to beat. Schieffer with the ball in his left hand. He's going to take it to the house. Wynford opens up the second half with a kick return touchdown.
Wynford facing a 4th and 9. Blair back deep to punt. Rugby style. Rolls out. Is blocked. Hit on that far side. Chased down by Tyrell. Tyrell, the all-conference MOAC player. Blocks it. Recovers it. And scores it.
Yep.
Lincoln Tyrell. Picking up right where he left off. Blocked the Caden Blair punt. I'll scoop it up. And I'll take it to the house. Make it 13-0.
He's literally the only player over there once he blocked it. There was no other Wynford Royal. They're trying to kind of do that rollout punt, but, you know, teams a lot of times have seen it, and they're very used to it. And there, Tyrell coming around the edge at 6'3", he gets those outstretched arms. I mean, you know, his arms are in the hair, up in the air to 6'7" or so, and just can't get it over the top of it. So blocked punt right there by Tyrell, and they're into the end zone.
13-0, 11:51 to go in the second quarter. Carver on now for the extra point. Snap is back. It's clean. Hold down, kick up, and the kick is good. Alan Carver makes it 14-0 with 11:51 to go in the second quarter. Wynford struggling here offensively. We'll see if they can get it going after this commercial break.
Hi, I'm Josh with Scout Construction, proud sponsor of local teams and athletes. Check out your favorite local sports right here on the OH Report.
Our you know, game MVP, and again, great play right there by Lincoln Tyrell, kind of puts that up into possibility. But the Lewis family McDonald's going to be sponsoring our player of the game all season, and they'll get themselves a gift card from McDonald's Family Restaurants as a result of a great performance. So we'll do that after the game. We'll pick a player for that, and we're excited about it for another season of high school football.
Galion Tigers both offensively and defensively looking mid-season form here. They got a special teams touchdown, an offensive touchdown. Gabe Ivey, one of the studs of the MOAC last year, and
yep,
he's put up good numbers already here in the first quarter. Carver checking the wind.
Yeah, the Royals, unfortunately, you know, between the penalties and then you get the block punt, you know, we knew that Galion was going to be very good this year, and we thought, okay, well, they're probably a little bit of a favorite, but Wynford's giving them a little bit too much here.
Kickoff fielded by Rinfus.
Oh,
Rinfus hit hard. Ball is out and scooped up, I believe, by the Royals. What a hit.
Yeah, that was a pop.
Crown
right
of the helmet right on the nose of the football. That's exactly how you teach it, Jeff.
Yes, exactly.
Rinfus popped up. It was a big hit, clean hit. Just put that helmet right on the football.
Yep. Couldn't have been done more perfectly right there. Just coming right in. And like you said, I mean, it's, you know, you're wrapping up and you're just kind of putting that helmet right into where the ball is. You're either trying to get your hand there or your helmet there. And there, you know, it was the helmet because the way that ball just popped up into the air.
Royals headed south. Two guys wide right, toss play goes to Blair. Blair shakes one tackle. Blair hit at the knees and knocked down. Short gain on the play. They'll give him five out to the 30-yard line. Good job breaking a tackle or two. Blair, very strong lower body.
Yeah. Yeah, never going to be easy to bring down.
Low center of gravity.
Low center of gravity. You know, and I'll say this, look, a five-yard gain, you know, Coach Skidmore will take that all day. That is the type of offense he'd love to run. Grind it away, he's happy with it.
Three backs behind Warren. They go fullback dive up the gut, and that is Blair again.
Yep.
Blair picks up five on that one. So exactly what Coach Skidmore wants. 5 yards in a cloud of dust.
Yep.
That's more efficient than what he hates.
Darn right. And, you know, part of a play like that is that, you know, you got Warren turning around and he's got both the other backs running in different directions.
And they're just backs that you have to respect.
Yes. So you're just trying to spread out that defense.
Again, Blair on the toss play moving near side. He's grabbed and slung down. This time maybe a gain of a foot.
The one thing that I think is kind of uniquely different about the offense that Wynford runs, this wing tee, versus wing tees we've seen over the years, is a lot of wing tees do a lot of misdirection where they send guys sort of, even though they're going one way, they've got somebody running in the other direction, and they sort of kind of keeps the defenders in place. This Wynford offense is much more just strong side run. You know, that's kind of where they're going, and that's what they're doing here.
A little bit of an end around with Rinfus. Call it a trap.
Yeah.
A little bit of trap block there. And on second down, Rinfus able to pick up 4.5.
Yeah, this offense is much more like, I'm going to put my 11 guys against your 11 guys. And I'm going to see if my guys can just push your guys out of the way. Like, it's I'm not trying to fool you here.
like Jerry Schlick once said, longtime football coach for Seneca East, why would you ever block backwards. You push people forward. I'm not pass blocking.
Mm-hmm. And there they
run
go right up
for
the
a
middle.
Short gain on two.
It's Blair, but again, it gets 2 yards, and
that's going to bring up 4th and 3.
And again, you know, they're still in their own territory here. So for Coach Skidmore, this is not an ideal scenario, and he's going to probably have to send out a punting unit. And they're going so slowly here that
taking their time. Ashton Warren exit the field, and here comes the punt team.
Yep. They're going to get there. A little hustle up now, but some late guys coming out. And that guy was sort of important because he's the long snapper.
Yeah. Chafin will stand at his 33-yard line, a dangerous returner.
Yep.
Blair, again, another rollout, short punt. Mm, oh,
no, not
goodness.
A good one.
And that's going to bounce at the 45, takes a little bit of a Wynford roll down to the 40, but
15-yard net punt, so it does not really work out terribly well. You know, sometimes, unfortunately, for the small schools, they don't have, you know, you don't get a kicker, you don't have somebody who punts real well on the roster or whatever, but they've been trying to do this rolling punt, obviously, and it's
I don't know if that's for momentum or what.
Yeah, it's the but it ain't
give
working.
Them an option to maybe run, but
yeah.
It's not worked so
it ain't
far.
It's working right now. So
Galion with great field position on all three drives. They started at the 44, the 41, and their own 40. Here they go with 8:55 to go, second quarter, leading 14-0. Two guys split wide left, one to the right. Prosser in a gun, has it, fakes the snap. Prosser going to run with it, trying to make a move in the open field. Gets by one, stiff arm to two, and shaken out of bounds. Renfus pushed him out, but he got off Blair, got off Evans, and a nice gain of six by Prosser, showing his moves in the open field.
Yeah, once again, defense that I thought early in the game was playing excellent. I'm doing a great job with angles. Here they took a bad angle. Once again, you know, just kind of got a little half shimmy move, like he was going to cut inside, was enough to make the defender freeze. That gave Prosser the window to get to the corner.
Cooper Kent comes wide left. Two riders, no, trips to the right side. They're going to go to Ivy. Ivy on a stretch play. Got by one guy. Ivy trying to stretch outside, and a great shoestring tackle made. Caden Blair got to him at the line of scrimmage. Literally, shoelaces brought him down.
And that's the type of defense that I thought Wynford was playing earlier that I was really impressed by. They were just coming at Galion in waves when they would tackle. You would see multiple blue jerseys there coming at least in the direction. So it doesn't give Ivy any place to really cut. He can't cut it inside. He can't necessarily go around the edges. There was three defenders around the corner waiting to make that tackle. So good job right there by the Royals. They just got to keep that type of momentum going.
Third and four. Two to the right for Prosser. Kent wide left. He is going to go back to Ivy. Ivy hitting the backfield, and he is rocked. Good gang tackle. Got him around the legs, and then Skidmore came in and cleaned it up.
Yep.
Ivy's going to have to readjust the jersey after that hit.
Yeah. Got about a yard on that play, but they're still in their own territory, and we'll see if Coach Dick, you know, he's got a two-score lead now. He can, you know, decide how aggressive he wants to be.
Initially tied up by Locker, and then Skidmore ended the play. Here we go, fourth and four, and it looks like they will bring out the punt team. Clock winding, 7:33 in the second. Galion leading 14-0. The rain has subsided, and it's quite the pleasant evening, actually.
Absolutely. For those who are afraid.
And they're going to fake it.
Is.
Up the middle, and it's a first down,
Big
Galion.
Big body, 77, Holden Hunter. I mentioned his name earlier, 6'3", 290 pounds. He's the personal protector and also the guy who can just going to run right up the middle on a play like that. But that's going to be the first down right there. And again, remember I said, when you get close to that middle of the field, mm-hmm. and you need short yardage, that's the time where teams like to go fake punt. And that's the reason why I say, usually on the return, I said it earlier, be a little conservative here because you got to expect its possibility. And I don't know how you stop 290 pounds.
Execution.
But
perfect execution.
They did it perfectly. You're right.
So now fresh set of downs for Galion. Prosser stands at his 50 in the gun. He's going to go to Ivy. Ivy looking for a hole right side. ISO play. Got off the second defender, and Ivy drives his way for a first down.
I think the ball came loose.
A helmet flies.
Yeah, he actually was past the first down marker. Got about 11 yards, but at the very end when he was trying to push for that little bit extra, he lost the ball. Luckily for him, Lincoln Tyrell there to pick it up for him. So it's going to end up being probably about an 8 to 9 yard pickup for Galion.
Not really sure who forced the ball
out
or if he just kind of slipped.
Too many guys in the area bunched together. Can't tell if somebody just got a hand on
it,
slapped it loose, or if it was, you know, after the – I think that usually it's a discussion of if it's – they're actually going to show a penalty, so it's a penalty on Galion. But I thought there was a possibility that maybe they were trying to figure out if he was down already. But and it was a – the penalty is actually going to move
pullers.
Him back.
Yep. But where did the penalty come in?
But it's actually coming up late because that was ends up being loss of six. So now they're looking at first and 16? Yeah, first replay the down. So
yep. 6:47 now in the first half. We will replay first down, and now we have more confusion. Near side official coming in from the Wynford sideline. Now they're going to reset the chains because those guys should have stayed put. Just the down marker needed to move back. That's our engineer. It's everybody's first game. Here we go, first and 15. Trips to the left side. Prosser has a pocket, wants to throw. Far sideline, one-on-one, and he let it too far. Mm-hmm. looking for Lincoln Tyrell out there, big body receiver. Tyrell at 6'3", one-on-one coverage over there with Anthony Evans. And Evans right on him. I don't know if Tyrell was really looking for that.
No, I don't know that he was either. But I think that's the sort of the type of play that Wynford is going to have to look at. They're going to have to put these receivers in man-to-man coverage because they're going to have to take everybody else and take them inside and take away the running game, or at least attempt to.
Shotgun, Ivy on the left hip, trips to the left. Prosser wants to throw, steps up left side, pressure in his face. Now he's going to scramble, gets by one, he's going back to the right side. And he's got pressure coming again, gets by another defender. Prosser slips, still on his feet. Prosser in the backfield, and eventually he had to go down. He lost two, but, man, he did his best Johnny Manziel.
That was he ran, I'm going to guess, 35 yards to lose two on that play. Evan, a lot of fun to watch, though.
Evan Wright coming at him from all angles, finally got over to him.
Evan Wright was upset because he was standing right in front of him the first time he had him.
Locker,
and then Prosser
kind of
took
there.
Off in the other direction. He was like, darn it. He had to chase him down. Wright's probably like, man, I'm a little more tired right now. I don't like chasing after guys like that. That's no fun.
So a long third down here with 5:40 and counting.
See if Winford does another three-man pressure and drop everybody else back.
Tight end right, three to the left. Prosser fakes the handoff. Prosser going to run it, looking for a hole, and not a lot on the quarterback keeper. Hit by Locker, also another stop, Jake Stover. And it'll be 4th and 12 inside Wynford territory, but still a 4th and 12. And if you're Galion, do you, take a shot here? Because Winford's offense hasn't been very effective.
Yeah.
Do you take a shot, try and keep the live game or the drive alive and put this game away, go up three scores?
If I'm Coach Dick, I punt. Because for the exact same reason, I'd play the field position game, hope that you can get the ball back with one more opportunity to score. But I would try to pin him back and see if you can get him on another three and out. And that's what Coach Dick is going to try to do here as he punts that one. Decent punt.
Yep, Campbell sends it down the far side. Official going to backtrack and put
15.
It about the 15-yard line. So 85 yards to go for the Wynford Royals. And their offense, as we just mentioned, has struggled so far. Ashton Warren throwing the football. He had one where he didn't quite get his shoulder closed.
Yeah.
He's throwing off balance. And another maybe just slipped out of his hands in these wet conditions. But he's got to get confidence throwing the football. That has to be an option for Coach Skidmore and the Wynford Royals.
I'm a big believer, as I said earlier, you've got to give your quarterback a couple of gimmies, especially quarterbacks who aren't necessarily – highly talented, no disrespect to Ashton Warren. Give him a gimme throw. That way it's easy.
Lob back to the left side. They faked it, play action. They wanted Rimfus, and it just wasn't there. Pressure on Warren right away, thrown off his back foot. They actually wanted Anthony Evans and just overthrew him.
And I'm a big believer, by the way, there you can kind of see what they were trying to do. Fake the handoff, get everybody up, and then you throw it over the top of everyone. But when I say a gimme, I mean it's like, let him catch it. Takes it.
Catch and throw.
Catch and throw. Or if you all have him under center, fine. Two-step drop, quick throw, hit a tight end. Do something easy. Where he's not going to have somebody in his face when he's making the throw as well.
Blair, Evans in the backfield. Here's Blair. Blair moving right side. Blair bounces it out. Blair up the sideline. Gets by another guy. Blair over the 30. He goes down at the 34-yard line. Very elusive run there by Caden Blair. Showing why he's gotten a majority of the carries so far tonight. And a little bit of life out of the Royal offense. First down.
I'll say it in a totally different way. It was really, he's been their only positive offensive player at this point in time. I mean, Rinfus has got a couple carries. He's got 6 yards. Evans has only got 1 yard. And Ashton Warren hasn't completed a pass yet. So Caden Blair and his 42 yards is the Wynford offense so far in this game.
Rinfus, Stover, split wide to the left. We got a tight end right in Kutalik. Warren under center, wants to throw. Bubble pass left side, and it's behind the line of scrimmage. Rinfus dropped it, and he has to cover it up.
Yeah, that's a loss.
That's going to be a huge loss back to the 27-yard line.
Again, if you want to –
that's the gimme you talk about, but you have to make it a gimme.
You have to execute
it right. You can't take advantage of the throw.
Yeah, you got to execute it right.
Step and hit your target in the chest.
You know, one of the reasons – when you're in high school, a lot of times high school because they're kids and they're young and they're learning. They don't understand why coaches want you to run the same things over and over again. But the reason for it is because a play like that or a penalty destroys your offensive opportunities. So there's Blair, nice little run, 4 yards. Mm-hmm. But they're still now looking at a third down and 13. You know, and if you don't pull out something outstanding here, they're going to punt the ball back to Galion, and they're going to have 2.5 minutes to go ahead and move their way and try to get more points back on the board. And it's all just because of a fundamental small mistake.
Try and dig it out here on third and 13. Even being a 3-year starter, you got to build confidence in a young kid.
Absolutely.
Two wide to the right, two guys in the backfield with Ashton. Ashton drops the back pass, has a nice pocket, lets
there
it go.
Is.
Rinfus wide open over the center of the field, behind everybody. Rinfus in a foot race. See you later. Wynford touchdown. Ashton Warren to James Rinfus, and that was a beautiful ball. Rinfus got behind everybody and beat them all to the end zone.
Yeah, the defenders, almost like they didn't believe that Ashton Warren could throw the ball that far. They kind of were sitting there, and Warren just sitting there in the pocket, had good protection, had a nice little arc around him, was able to step into it. There was no, like, floating away. He just stepped in, put a nice pass down there. And like I said, Cooper Kent playing defensively, playing in that cornerback position, sort of got to let Rinfus go a little bit. And it just dropped in right behind him, and then it becomes a foot race, and Rinfus in the foot race runs away from everybody. They weren't going to catch him from there.
What a call there. What could have been potentially a punt. Wynford on the extra point. It is up, and it is good. So it is 14-7. What could have been disastrous for Wynford, giving the ball back to Galion, potentially going down 3 scores. A huge connection between Ashton Warren and James Rinfus, and it's a 1-score game here with 2:50 to go in the first half. Galion 14, Wynford 7.
Hi, I'm Josh with Scout Construction, proud sponsor of local teams and athletes. Check out your favorite local sports right here on the OH Report.
WQEL and streaming live online on the OH Report. It's a 1-score game between the Galion Tigers and the Wynford Royals. Deep ball connection between Ashton Warren and James Rinfus. And you know, we talked about it a little bit in the pregame. Ashton was going to have to find a new favorite target, and it was almost going to have to be James Rinfus in this wing tee offense, and a good connection for 6 there. Kick fielded by the up man. That is Chafin. Chafin still on his feet, stretches left side,
boy.
And a lot of room to run. Chafin at the 40, 35, 30, hurdles a man at the 25. Chafin still on his feet. He's going to go all the way. Chafin for the touchdown.
Colin Holzmeier, the kicker. They got him at 5'7". That feels like a gift. But he tried to kind of just go low around the 25-yard line, just, you know, hoping to maybe get him, wrap him around the ankle or something like that. And he's just like, no. I'm a little more athletic than that. I'll just pop right over the top of you. There you go. And he was actually slipping down to the ground, so let's cut him a little slack there.
Chafin with his best Peyton Hillis.
Yes, absolutely. Good reference. Good call.
Go back old school with it.
No doubt.
Put him on the Madden cover.
Woo.
So Elijah Chafin answers the Wynford score with one of his own, and it is 20-7. On to attempt the extra point. Carver. Kick is up, and the kick is good. 21-7 following the kick return for a touchdown by Elijah Chafin. Wynford will have it back with 2:32 to go first half. Yard line takes it to the house on the kick return, and the Galion Tigers leading this Crawford County rivalry 21-7.
Yeah, very impressive. And unfortunately, you know, when you're working as a head coach before the season starts, you know, a lot of coaches, it's like, all right, we got to work on offense, we got to work on defense, and the special teams become sort of on the side. But unfortunately, Galion's got 14 of their 21 points coming because of special teams. At this point in time against Wynford, a block punt, now the kick return.
A great kick by Carver into the end zone, and it will be a touchback. So the Wynford Royals will have it first and 10 from the 20.
And a quick reminder once again that after our game, we'll be picking our Lewis family McDonald's players of the game. We'll pick one from both teams, Wynford and Galion, and they'll each get themselves a gift certificate from McDonald's of Bucyrus, Galion, and all over, Lewis family McDonald's all over Ohio. So, again, we appreciate them for that. And also congrats to Gabe Ivey, who became our very first Chevy of Bucyrus Save More on Route 4 first score of the game.
Whistles will blow this play dead, and it's going to be a timeout Wynford. So before the drive even begins, Coach Skidmore wants to talk things over with his offensive personnel. 2:32 to go in the first quarter. So let's go ahead and take a quick timeout. We'll be right back on WQEL and the OH Report.
Hi, I'm Josh with Scout Construction, proud sponsor of local teams and athletes. Check out your favorite local sports right here on the OH Report.
Crew at Mizek Miller, Plymal Insurance, as well as Raw Supply and everybody at WQEL. Live highlights as we highlight top performers from the gridiron in the past week. So check out the new high school football final show on the Facebook pages of Mizek Miller, Plymal Insurance, Raw Supply, WQEL, First Federal Community Bank. Out of the timeout, first and 10 for the Royals and senior quarterback Ashton Warren. Renfrews wide right. He's going to spin, give. Here's Evans. Jump cut in the backfield. Evans over the 20. Gets to the 21-yard line. Not a lot of space for Evans.
Nope. And again, you know, for the Galion Tigers, they're continuing, even though they just gave up that big touchdown pass, they're going to continue to just focus on the running game. I think that, you know, when a team can score and they get a big touchdown like that, even though it sometimes opens things up, a lot of times defensive coordinators are like, nah, that's a fluke. You ain't going to get another one like that. So,
this time they go to Blair. Blair still on his feet, spinning off defenders in a gain of 9 up to the 30-yard line. Nice job by Caden Blair. That's that low center of gravity we talked about. Able to bounce off arm tackles, weak tackles. Blair keeps it alive and moves the chains.
Yeah, very good run right there by Caden Blair. He's been consistently the strongest effort right there on offense, with the exception being that big Renfrews touchdown catch. He's been their offense at this point.
Under center again for Warren on first and 10. Renfrews wide right, Blair in the backfield. He wants to throw it, rolling right into the flats. He's got Evans. Evans connects on the 42-yard line, and he's pushed out of bounds. Great play design there. Evans sneaking out from the wing, and the defender a little late to get there. Great pitch and catch with Warren and Evans. And that's the arm strength by Ashton Warren. You want him to get more square with his body, but he relies on that arm, and that's the strength right there showed it. He was off balance, but still able to deliver that pass.
Mm-hmm. When he follows mechanics, he throws as good a ball as we see. Mm-hmm. It's just oftentimes he floats a lot, and he doesn't do that.
End around, here's Rimfus looking for a block. James to the second level. Oh, and a shoestring tackle brings him down after a gain of 9.5. He gets by that, and it's another foot race for Rinfus.
Yep, it would have been him and Ivy racing to the edges, and if he's able to get past them, that would have been it.
Great steal block by Evans, and Skidmore comes and pulls through a huge block and a touchdown-saving tackle by Elijah Chafin. Wynford hurries up. Ashton under center. He is going to shuffle out Rinfus, and they go for a reverse play. Flags – or no, the beanbag, sorry.
Everywhere.
And they were trying to get tricky there, but the initial handoff between Warren and Evans didn't go as planned.
Well, every single official, every one of them, saw the exact same penalty. So, I think it was a pretty obvious one what happened.
Now we are inside a minute to go here in the first half. The Royals will take a timeout. We'll go ahead and keep it right here on WQEL and the OH Report. Of course, it is Thursday night. Couple teams in action tonight. Colonel Crawford down at River. Mohawk in a big rivalry game taking on Tiffin Calvert. That's over on WBCO. Tim Byrie, Jared Moore on the coverage of that one. And that is, Crawford score 14-0 over River. And Calvert leading 7-6 over Mohawk. Appreciate you, Mr. Holden. So a dogfight, and that's a rivalry that goes back decades, all the way into the 70s.
Type of game that when they ended up off of each other's schedule when Mohawk joined the N10, I was excited that they put it back on the schedule as a non-league game.
A lot of time for Ashton Warren wanting to throw. Now he's going to tuck and go. Ashton, 45, 50, hit, goes into his own sideline, driven out of bounds by Gabe Ivy. At the 49, we'll see exactly where they spot it. Yep, it'll be the 49 of Galion.
It's going to be interesting.
And I believe this is the first time, other than on the touchdown play, that Wynford has been in Galion territory.
This is actually an interesting call here because, obviously you're down two touchdowns. You got a fourth down, you need about 3 yards, and you're barely in Galion territory. I mean, that gives you a lot of options. Maybe you just go hard count here. And
I think Galion's going to take their final
timeout.
They will.
Yeah, he's not going to take his chances.
So Galion burns their third and final timeout. So with 50 seconds to go here in the first half, both teams will talk over this fourth and four. 21-7, Galion over Wynford. We'll be right back.
Hi, I'm Josh with Scout Construction, proud sponsor of local teams and athletes. Check out your favorite local sports right here on the OH Report.
WQEL.com, also streaming live online on the OH Report. I'm Josh Stallings, back for another season of high school football beside Jeff Roberts. It's Thursday night here at Wynford. Crawford County rivalry between the Galion Tigers and the Wynford Royals, and it's been an interesting first half. Had a blocked punt touchdown. We've had a kick return for a touchdown.
Wouldn't be surprised to see Wynford come out hard count. Nope, they'll just go straight to Blair.
Blair trying to carry it. He's got the sticks, and I think he's got enough for the first down.
Yeah, he got it. That is a senior who's played a lot of time on varsity, who understands not only where he's got to go, but how to get there. Because, it's not that bodies weren't hitting him. I mean, he gets hit for the first time 2 yards, but he
Nobody's
lowered his shoulders.
The sticks yet.
And everybody just kind of kept fighting. And they had him up around the shoulders, but they didn't have his arms wrapped up, so he was able to just kind of reach out with his arm to get it a little forward.
Royals in a hurry up. One-man route. Warren going to throw it deep. Rinfus one-on-one. He's got a step. Rinfus is out there.
My goodness.
He hauls it in. Touchdown. James Rinfus in a dot from Ashton Warren. An absolute dot.
A perfect pass and a great route because Rinfus, as he's sort of running, he's sort of jogging next to the defender. They're basically just kind of going stride by stride. And then at the last minute, he just breaks away from him, you know. And Galion, despite the fact that it's a one-person route, there's still only man covering him. Nobody's going over to help out. So once that defender sort of kind of just fell asleep out there and Wynford's pulled away from him, there's nobody to help on the play, and it's in for the touchdown.
And Ashton Warren has no read on that play. It's drop back and huck it. It's a one-man route, and it worked to perfection there. Snap back, kick up. Flag is out. The extra point is good. I don't know if somebody was covering the center there and blew him up. 21-14. The Ashton Warren, James Rinfus connection once again. And what a route, what a ball.
Yeah, well, we'd like to, you know what's funny is that you say like, yeah, what a route and what a ball, but it's like there was actually nothing special about the route. It's called
go.
Run straight.
Just blew by Alan Carver out there playing one-on-one coverage. They put him on an island with James Rinfus, and Rinfus wants that smoke all day.
Yep. And again, James Rinfus now two catches, 115 yards, two touchdowns. That's how Winford's getting their offense.
Randy Moss numbers.
Right.
And Wynford on the sideline following the penalty, so I think they're just going to accept it. Decline the penalty, accept the point. It's a personal foul against Galion.
Yep. See, if you
penalty is declined. Okay.
Yep, there it
is. I don't know why we had such a discussion, but it is week one of high school football, so everybody's got to get in the zone.
Chances are, because if I was Coach Skidmore, he was probably asking, can I have it put into my kickoff?
Yeah.
I'll take the point, but I would like the 15 yards in the kickoff, and they were probably like, no, you can't do that.
Back to a one-score game here at Wynford, 21-14. The Galion Tigers still in control, but Wynford with a lot of momentum here. See if they can hold it and go into the half just down one. We'll take a quick break. We'll be right back for the final 33 right after this.
Calvert with the minuscule advantage.
Galion will have the ball back with 33 seconds. Let's see what Coach Dick wants to do. Fielded by the up man, and did he get totally terrible. To a knee there?
No, but he gave a wave.
Yeah, okay.
He gave the wave before it got there. And remember, earlier in the game, the ball got kicked to him, and it bounced off
That's
his hands
true.
And moved forward. He was like,
chance.
I'm not doing that again.
So, Galion again with pretty good field position, starting at their own 35.
In the since Wynford scored at 2:50 left, there's been 21 points put on the board in the last, when we got here, 2 minutes and 18 seconds. Guys, see if they want to try to do one more. See if they can get Ivy broken loose. Nope. They'll just take the knee.
Skidmore gives holding Hunter a good shove there, knocked him down. Prosser just a simple knee and shouldn't have to run another play, I don't believe. Clock down to 15. 21-14. Stay tuned at the half. It's the Ken Standing Seam Halftime Show brought to you by Ken and Matt Studer at Ken Standing Seam. Phone Matt today at 419-544-6275. That is our friend Matt Studer at 419-544-6275. And that'll do it. Takes us to the break here at Wynford. With a high-octane final 2 minutes of this first half, 21-14, the Galion Tigers on top of the Wynford Royals. We'll be right back. Are you ready for the comeback?
Take a look at all the action from Friday Night Football right here in North Central Ohio with great analysis, highlights, coach interviews, and so much more every single Friday night right here on the OH Report.
He's going to send a line drive down the field. It'll be fielded on the bounce. That is Schieffer. Schieffer finds a hole at the center. Schieffer turns on the burners. Schieffer could go. He's at the 50, 45. He's got one man to beat. Schieffer with the ball in his left hand. He's going to take it to the house. Wynford opens up the second half with a kick return touchdown.
Just play St. Joe's. the way, before they scored those, about 5 minutes left in the second quarter, I wrote this note for very quickly. It just says, their offense blows. I have a way about me, you know? I was like, what is this?
Us though either, who knows?
All right.
22 minutes left.
Thank you so much.
On the 22 commercials. Yeah, no. Okay. I was afraid with the minutes. I was like, oh, boy, that's going to be awful. Okay. 22 commercials is that after the after what we're doing? Okay, so I'm going to bust out these stats very quickly, so we might be able to squeeze in another minute here at halftime. Okay. Yeah, we might try to make it a three, is what I'm trying to say. Maybe even more. I'm gonna pick this up and put it down. Okay. Right.
That's true. Yeah.
It does. Well, look, when it comes out, I'm going to do this real quick. I'm going to try to get this done as fast as possible, in and out on these because they're sort of unofficial anyway. Right.
Ladies and gentlemen, tonight the Marching Royals will take you on a trip to the stage. Our show tonight features music from three different Broadway hits. Our first selection comes from the Broadway musical that features music from the group ABBA. Here is I Have a Dream from Mamma Mia.
They're not doing the halftime show.
Yeah, we'll find you.
Yep.
We are back here at the break from Wynford High School. Galion with a first half lead, 21-14 over the Wynford Royals in this season opener, Thursday night, week number one, and it's been an interesting first half, to say the least. Looked like Galion might run away with this thing, get up three scores. All of a sudden, we see 21 points scored in the final 2 minutes of this game, or the final 2 minutes of the first half, and it's a 21-14 game. Wynford's got a little life, a couple deep connections between James Rifus and Ashton Ward, and that offense is maybe not rolling, but it's getting a little bit more efficient.
The way I would call it is that we have got an interesting game here as a result of bad special teams by Wynford and bad defensive breakdowns by Galion. That's basically why we've got so many points on the board. Without that, it has really just turned into one D-by-game run and has really made the offensive scoreboard. But again, as it turns out, we've seen five touchdowns, and it's as a result of those touchdowns.
Two special teams touchdowns. Yep. Lincoln Tyrell, the block punt, recovers in the end zone for a score. Elijah Chaffin returns a kickoff to the house for a touchdown. And other than that, offensively, it's just a game Ivy.
No, it is. I mean, like, and that's actually, as I'm going to look at the numbers right here, let's just do this. These are very unofficial, but, you know, Gabe Ivy, he's got 12 carries, 69 yards, the touchdown run. But when you hear the rest of the offense, you're going to be like, oh, really? Yeah, he's got 21 points on the board. Because he's got the 69 yards. Behind him, Holden Hunter, the 290-pound lineman, has got an 8-yard run that he had on a, you know, a fake punt. They got 1 yard out of Carson Frankhouse on 2 carries. And then Braxton Prosser's got 5 carries for -2 yards. So I've got him at 23 carries, 76 yards, 1 touchdown running. And then throwing the ball, Prosser has completed 1 of 2 passes. It went to Elijah Chaffin for -1 yard. So as a team, Galion's only got 75 yards of offense. Wynford, on the other hand, if you look at them on the ground, they've actually got a lot more yardage, and it's really just because they're 2 big passes. Caden Blair had been their only offense before that. He had 10 carries, 58 yards. James Renfrew's 4 carries, 7 yards. Ashton Moran, 1 carry, 4. And then Anthony Edwards has got 5 carries for -4 yards. So as a team, they have 20 carries, 65 yards. So for a team that likes to run the football, that's not a great yards per carry average. But then Ashton Moran, who was incomplete passes all over the place, they've got it together, completed 3 of 6 for 128 yards, 2 touchdown throws, both from deep ones to James Renfrew, who's 2 catches, both for touchdowns, 115 yards for him. Anthony Edwards has got a catch for 13. And I've got Wynford at 193 yards of offense today.
For our second selection, we feature music from the Smash and Broadway that tells the untold true story.
I appreciate that. But ultimately, what I'm saying here is that, you know what,
featuring a duet by Grace Everett and Abby Root, here is Defying Gravity.
Players doing anything that's kind of giving them anything there offensively. And for, you know,
know, for Galion, it's Gabe Ivey who's the only one that's giving him anything.
That was on a drive that was extended because of the flag on the ground.
Yes. So now what we're sitting here looking at is you got two coaches going to a locker room. One who's sitting there going, hey, if we could just stop these deep passes, we got a huge lead here. And the other one that's saying, we would have been winning this game if we could stop some special teams mistakes.
Simple breakdown. Simple. It's week one of high school football. That's exactly what it's boiling down to. Sloppiness in certain aspects of the game, taking certain plays off, losing focus at certain times. But we're in a tight ballgame, an exciting ballgame. 21-14 is a beautiful night. The rain has passed over us. It's calm, it's cool, and now, I mean, it's still a little bit of a cross breeze, but you're starting to feel like maybe Ashton Ward's got a little bit of confidence. Prosser has fumbled two of the snaps that he wanted to throw on. You know, if it dries up a little bit, we might see these guys maybe take a little bit more shots.
Well, I think that if nothing else, Wynford has shown that if we give Ashton Ward some time, he can sit in that pocket and throw a few nice passes. You know, we just gotta give him that opportunity to be able to do the right things with the football. And they also know that James Rinfus is a little bit of a difficult matchup, especially for the deep, because he's a lot faster than the Galion Tigers thought he was.
Here at the half, it's Galion 21, Wynford 14. The penalties, Wynford 4, Galion 2, and Galion has dominated the field position battle, but yet still only leading by 7. 21-14 at the break. We'll take a timeout. We'll be right back.
Go both 3 minutes here, okay? And when they come out, they might do an add-on of more time. So if they do, we might be able to. They've been doing that for years. I would assume they do the same. So expect to do the 3 minutes and the bump here, but don't be surprised if we take another break.
You gotta get as much as.
Good, okay. Nope, appreciate you, bud. I told them that.
For our final selection, we take you back to the Paris Opera House, where a masked figure lurks in the catacombs underneath and terrorizes all who inhabit the Opera House's walls. From the iconic 1986 Broadway musical, here is the title song, Phantom of the Opera.
If we
want to
do something fast, I don't know if you have games, whatever.
favorable for how the wind is blowing. It's kind of coming crossways, but it's going more northeast. So a little bit more favorable for Ashton Warren. His two touchdown completions have been to Rinfus going to the other end zone.
Yeah.
But, hey, we'll see what Coach Skidmore and this Royal offense want to do as we open up the second half.
Yeah, I think that, you know, if, like I said, if there's something that they learned is that, all right, if we give Ashton Warren the time, we let him set it up a little bit, we might be able to get some things open down the field. And I think that would be really good for this offense that, you know, as much as I know Coach Skidmore wants to keep it, you know, ground and pound, tight matchups, whatever. I mean, unfortunately, if you're just keep getting, you know, 3 yards and they get, you know, you hit a, get hit with a penalty or something like that, the drive gets killed. All it takes is one small mistake, and that's all it takes for it to kind of just fall apart. So, you know, just being able to add in a little sprinkling of some passing or some misdirection runs, I think will do a lot of wonders for this Wynford offense.
The Royals actually with more, doubling up the Galion Tigers in first downs. They have eight in the first half compared to Galion's four. Passing yards, 127 to negative one unofficially. Yep. Rushing yards, 77 to 75 in favor of Galion. Or total yards, 202 to 76. And, of course, no turnovers so far, but those special teams breakdowns by Wynford or whatever you want to call them in terms of favoring Galion. But I would call them breakdowns. You can't have punts blocked. You cannot let, especially short kickoffs, be returned for touchdowns. You got to have containment. You got to step up and block those guys. The special teams game, you cannot give extra opportunities, especially to a team like Galion.
Well, exactly, because I think coming into the game, we thought we were going to have a good matchup, but we just thought because of the amount of good, talented players Galion had coming back, they were going to be tough to stop. And Wynford has been there. They've stuck their head in, and they've made it tough on them. I mean, Ivy's got some yardage, but a lot of them came on one run. So, honestly, they've done a pretty good job defensively, but they've got to clean up these mistakes. Otherwise, this game's going to get away from them. You know, so this is the type of thing that it can still go either way, depending on, you know, who corrects the mistakes they're making.
Update from around the area. Mohawk has scored now. They take the lead. They lead it 12-7 over Calvert. That's it. Game is in the third quarter. And Colonel Crawford trailing River 14-0. We'll be back with the third quarter right after this. From Mohawk and Calvert. Mohawk takes the lead 12-7. They go for the two-point conversion. No good as Ben Bogner tried to scramble, cut back across the field. So it is a one-score game up in Sycamore. The Warriors trying to get a big win over Tiffin Calvert. I know Calvert faithful, pretty high hopes going into this season playing in the SBC. They had a lot of guys coming back, a lot of size on that team. And if Mohawk can go and steal one at home,
be huge
going into their season because they have a very tough non-con.
And quite honestly, like, you know, from what we saw last year, I remember at the beginning of the season to the end of the season, I was like, Ben Bogner has really improved a lot. Like, I mean, that was a kid that from week one when we first saw him to week 10, I was like, he's a totally different quarterback. So,
and for the first time since a long time, Mohawk hasn't had a quarterback battle going into the season.
Exactly.
So they knew what they were going to have, a leader at quarterback, and Bogner certainly stepping up. Good kick as we open up the second half. It's going to be fielded by Anthony Evans at the five. Evans up the center of the field. Evans jump cut. Evans shakes one, shakes two. Evans still going, and he is up across the 25 to the 27-yard line.
I think he was wrapped up by his own player. I mean, yeah. I think that's what
there's
stopped his
momentum. There's a lot of cluster going on.
A lot of guys going in there, and we're getting the replay on the OH report. And, yep,
he
there
was
it is.
Bumped, ran into by number 12, Aiden Mason.
You're like, all right, kid, don't worry about it, but, you know. Let's try to not make that a habit.
Exactly.
Pretty good return, though, for a deep kick, you know. So
tight formation. Warren under center. He's going to give fullback dive straight up the middle, and the ball came out.
Yep, it sure did, and Galion is saying they've got it.
Galion does have it. So the opening play of the second half, the Galion Tigers come up with the Caden Blair fumble.
Yep.
Blair lined up in a three-point stance. Did he have a clean handoff? It was clean. Just punched out from behind.
Yep.
Great play by the defensive tackle to wrap him up and punch that ball out from behind, and Galion gets the first turnover of the night.
Yeah, that actually worked out pretty darn well for Galion again because, like I said, he was kind of just stymied right away. He got bodies on him pretty quickly, didn't have any place to go. And when the defender came from behind, he was able to just knock it loose.
So excellent field position for the Galion Tigers. They're going to give to Ivy. Ivy's tried the middle, going to bounce it outside, gets off an arm tackle. Ivy's got a first down up the sideline, and he's going to fall inside the 20, inside the 15, goes down at the 12-yard line, and Ivy just showing the speed. He had nothing up the middle, just that jump cut, able to get to the outside, good seal block, and was nobody home.
And a lot of times with plays like that, and I think it's a perfect example, it's a defense over pursuing. It's a play that they can see is intended to go sort of between the tackles. And when Ivy realizes I don't really have any place there, he just bounces it out and it becomes a foot race between him and Rinfus to the corner. Mm-hmm. And he was able to get there. And
Rinfus
once he did,
got
it's
caught
open.
Inside. Yeah. You got to keep contained.
That's it.
Two guys wide, one right, one left. They go to the back. Here's Ivy hitting the backfield, and he is wrapped up and brought down.
Not that time. You know.
52, Bryce Locker.
Yep.
Shut the door in the backfield, 3-yard loss. And he tried the old scoop slam.
He was going for the suplex.
Yeah, and, luckily he didn't get it fully because that's a penalty anymore.
Yep, exactly. I'll tell you what, that was, Bryce Locker is having a heck of a game, though, so far. He's been all over the place.
Prosser in the gun. He is going to have a lead blocker in front, going to try and run left side, hit in the backfield, and dropped. Well, he was able to get maybe two on that play, was able to fall forward, Blair and Locker on the stop. We saw Prosser run a few times in their opening drive, and he's going to face a third and 13 here from the Wynford 13.
Yeah, Prosser's athletic. I mean, he can get out in that open field. He's pretty dangerous, but Winford's doing a good job keeping them contained.
The Tigers need the two for a first down. Ball is at the 14-yard line. Prosser fakes it, throws it, slant, almost intercepted by Ashton Warren.
Yep.
He was more focused on the receiver, which you can't fault him for that, but if he keeps his head on a swivel there, he might be still running the other direction.
Well, you know, when you do that play, that quick snap, turn, and throw, you have to pre-snap read it a little bit and pay attention to where the guys are. Warren was already biting on the route a little bit. He knew where it was going, kind of took a little bit of a step in. And once he did that, that takes that route away. Mm-hmm. And as a quarterback, you have to kind of be paying attention to that.
So after the excellent field position, the Wynford defense trying to hold him to three. It will go for the field goal, and it is tipped at the line. Does it have enough to get there?
Nope.
No, it does not. A blocked field goal. Alan Carver's kick was tipped in the back. I think it might have been Ashton Warren. Mm-hmm. Here's the instant replay. Getting through there. And it wasn't Ashton.
No, one of the defensive linemen got through. Did a good job.
What a stand by the Wynford Royal defense. Yeah. The Galion Tigers have had excellent field position all night. They get their best there starting at the Royal 31, and they hold.
Yep, once again, a bunch of bodies going in through one area. And again, on the replay, it's just a little too blurry for us to catch the number, but still great play right there by the Wynford Royals.
Certainly appreciate still the live highlights from the OH report.
Thank you to the OH report for that.
Jet motion. Ashton Warren fakes the pitch. He's going to run up the middle, and Ashton's got a gain of 9.
See, this is the type of stuff I'm talking about. That is a play that they haven't run before. And whenever Wynford throws anything different, anything unique, they get yards. Mm-hmm. Like it
they got to have confidence in it.
Yes. I mean, they had never done a fake pitch. You know,
great trap block there by Jake Stover.
Love it. It was a very good play, good 10-yard run. And, again, you know, for Wynford, they got to feel great. They come out first play, they fumble. Galion comes out, gets a 20-yard run from Ivy, and it's like, oh, boy, this isn't going to good. But they hold him out, and now they get a first down.
Tigers go heavy in the box, and Anthony Evans slips to the secondary.
Boy.
Evans at the 50, inside Galion territory, hanging onto the football, and Anthony Evans with his biggest carry of the night. He's jacked up. Ball down to the 40-yard line of Galion.
Best
and
run.
Galion loaded the box. A little bit of misdirection there by the Wynford Royals and Anthony Evans, and Evans showing his elusiveness. Gets it in a big gain into Galion territory.
Yeah, best run of the game for them, 30 yards. And, again, you could just see it the moment he touched that ball, that end was sealed off. One of the very first times we've really seen it where he was going to go off that tackle coming on the end around, and there was not going to be anybody for the Galion Tigers who were going to be able to get him.
Two backs and a three-point behind Ashton Warren. Toss play, Blair moving right side, jump cut. Blair gets off one, but a swarming tackle by the Galion Tigers, and he wasn't getting out of there. Frank House, as well as Tyrell over there. Also, number 13, Sam Evans.
Yeah,
big-time play by the sophomore.
And you can kind of see they're pulling linemen right there. You know, Kalen Skidmore is coming from the other side, and we love Kalen Skidmore as a lineman, but he's just not able to get around fast enough. So he basically is, you know, unless Blair wants to slow down the run a lot to let him come over. But that's going to let more defenders come over and realize where he's going. They got to pull those guys out and get him out a little bit faster.
Second and 11. Warren fakes the handoff, wants to throw, rolling left. He is pressured, and he's dropped in the backfield. Huge loss all the way back in Royal territory at the 48-yard line. And he had pressure from all angles, had nowhere to really step up.
Yeah.
That's another, you know, he's only got one, maybe two reads on that play. And if it's not there, he's pretty much got to eat it or throw it away.
And that's, I think, part of when Warren is playing. Like, we've seen in this game when he's got time and he can process and he can step in the ball into a throw, he's been outstanding. When he gets pressure, you can see a little bit of panicky. And right there, you can see it. He's like, I got a guy coming on me. And he basically fell right away.
Here's third and 21, wants to throw it, has time. Guy wide open across the middle, that's Evans. Got 10 yards back, so he'll get to the original line of scrimmage. Evans had a little bit of an opening there. Good pitch and catch by Ashton Warren. Wynford trying to tie it up here, but a big fourth and 11 now.
But I love that play. That's the type of play that I like. I was talking about early in the game about letting your quarterback in an easy throw. That, I mean, you can just see Ashton Warren's got a totally different level of confidence than he did when the game first started. I mean, he's feeling very good throwing that ball around. And this makes it, you know, manageable to try to go for it. You know, fourth down 11, we go for it now. Let's see what we can do.
Stover goes in motion, wants to throw. He's going to scoop to the up man. It's Blair fighting for it. And he's going to be about a yard and a half shy. He outstretched the football, but a good tackle made by Hunter Menard.
They did the misdirection. You know, they
that
pulled
shovel.
Everybody right, and they just did the Statue of Liberty to Blair underneath. And unfortunately, you can see on the play, Blair didn't – he needed a second. He needed a half a second to tuck it in. Mm-hmm. Like, it was a little loose, and that half a second may have cost him. I mean, that's not even a half a second, probably a quarter second. But, you know, it was a good play. It was a good, well-executed – caught Galion off guard, but they needed 11, only got about 9.5.
7:07 to go, third quarter. Prosser in the gun, has a snap. Pressure, Ivy hitting the backfield, and he's going to be dropped. He was able to get back to the line and fall forward for a half a yard. But good flow by the Wynford defense there. Stover in on the stop. Stretching it out was Bryce Locker.
Yep.
They're actually going to give him about 2 yards.
Yeah, kind of fell himself forward in the pile of mess. So that'll end up getting some good yardage there.
Calvert taking a deep shot on that play, and it is a circus catch made. So Calvert making a push, still trailing 7-12, but an incredible catch there. Here is Prosser in the gun, wants to throw across the middle. Post is tipped, intercepted. Blair on the tip ball, up the Galion sideline. Blair gets a block, cuts to the center of the field. Caden Blair still on his feet, looking back to the middle. Blair switches hands up the 20, 15-yard line. He goes down. Caden Blair on the tip pass, and another huge play by this Wynford defense.
They're all over the place. I mean, they try to go to Chafin on that play. And again, Prosser's always trying to kind of fight that ball into to the guy he wants to get it to. But defense is right there on top of it. And again, ball's just a little bit high. Defender on the play, Ashton Warden, comes over the top and just slaps it down. And when it did, it just popped up into the air. And Blair, coming back from the linebacker spot, just has a free shot to be able to pick it up and gets a nice return. Got it at about the 50, brought it all the way down to the 17-yard line.
The Wynford defense coming up big once again. First and 10 now. Ashton Warren back on the field. It'll be from the 17. Heavy formation. Everybody packed in. Three backs in the backfield. Here's James Rinfus on the carry. Rinfus on the counter. Gets inside the 15. And the ball come out. It did. Oh, excuse me. That was Evans. But
Wynford able to
recovered.
Pick it up.
56. Chris Everett able to get on it.
Big play right there by Everett. Don't want to stop the momentum of this drive.
Everett missed his block, but luckily he missed his block because he was behind the play to pick that ball up.
That's exactly right. I mean, it actually is one of those bizarre situations that why you tell your players never give up on a play, because you never know when it might bounce. And that ball just bounced right to his lap.
5:35 and counting, 21-14. Wynford trying to tie this thing up. Warren spins, gives. Ball goes up the middle. I think it was Blair.
I think so, too.
Not a lot of space for him, though. Tied up inside. Jacob Chambers in on the stop. A couple other Galion Tigers in there. Yep. 15, Trey Longwell.
Yeah, I don't think didn't get anything on that play. But, again, you know, for Wynford, I think if you're Coach Skidmore, you're looking at it saying, all right, well, I got two plays here, though, to go. 7 yards, seven and a half yards, you know. So, your playbook can get a little more open.
Mm-hmm.
Try to get, at least four of it, five of it here.
They will spread it out a little. Rinfus, Stover, wide left. Now the motion of third guy. That's Blair into the slot. Warren, hands up the middle.
Evans, but
and the ball loose again.
Yeah,
and a slippery playing surface. And they're going to give the ball to Galion on another turnover.
Evans making that carry, bringing it right up the middle. Now, Wynford players are trying to say, no, he was down, but
here we go on the replay.
Galion's already making
the changeover. Evans up the middle, and the ball is definitely loose.
Came loose. I mean, it was a nice play. He tried to do a spin when he got to the pile, and it left the ball loose, and somebody was able to knock it loose.
So Wynford got the takeaway, but they give it right back to the Galion Tigers.
So many
turnovers in the first half. We've seen three to start the third quarter.
I was going to say, in a game that's been pretty, we can tell, these are two pretty good teams. It has still had a lot of week one mistakes,
mm-hmm.
From both of them. I mean, both of them kind of putting some errors out there and giving the other team an opportunity to take away with this game or go away with this game.
Landon Prosser under center. He's going to give. The back is Ivy, tried to bounce it out wide to the right. Hit made on that play by Chandler Elkert. Gain of five, though. So they have Galion in their worst starting field position, but Coach Skidmore going to have to ask his defense one more time to step up, keep this thing to a one-score game.
And this is the type of game that really Coach Skidmore wants. He wants teams to have to get the ball and try to go 85 yards on us. Like this is, this is perfect in terms of the way he likes to see the outlook of the game.
Braxton in the gun, gives to Ivy, and he is hit and dropped right away. Maybe a gain of a half a yard on that one. I think that was Kotalik, the big fella in there on the stop.
Yeah, Kotalik makes it quite difficult to run right up the middle because
6'8", 270.
At his size, And part of what we saw last year, it's not just it's his wingspan. Because,
mm-hmm.
Sometimes he can't get right in front of you, but he's one of the rare guys that can kind of reach out, get a hand on you, and just with one arm stop your momentum.
Chambers wide to the right. One wide receiver goes wide to the left. Prosser under the gun. Now Chambers is going to go in motion. doubles on the left side, fakes the handoff. He's going to throw back right into the flats. He's got a man wide open. Foot race up to the 30 and a first down. And easy pitch and catch there to Lincoln Tyrell. And Tyrell just slipped from his slot position, and the linebacker in man coverage was just late to get there. That's Rinfus.
Yeah, he was getting caught up looking into the backfield a little bit, trying to make sure that Prosser wasn't going to run with the football, and he was able to give Tyrell a little bit too much space down there on the sideline.
So a fresh set of downs now for Galion. Two to the right, two to the left. Prosser wants to throw. Stop route. Pass complete. Gets off one. Trying to drive through the arm tackle.
Tyrell again.
Wynford gets a couple more hats over there, and it'll be a short gain of three. Rinfus in there, as well as Evan Wright.
Yep, and I think it was Tyrell. He's down right now. He kind of took the tackle, went to get up. He put his hands up for some help, and then he just kind of laid right back down.
So an injury timeout here from Wynford. It's 21-14. The Galion Tigers over the Royals here in week number one. 2:51 to go, third quarter. We'll be right back.
Hi, I'm Josh with Scout Construction, proud sponsor of local teams and athletes. Check out your favorite local sports right here on the OH Report.
Playing in the Little League World Series. They are currently tied 3-3, game in the fourth inning. Also from around the area, Calvert and Mohawk still battling it out. That is 14-12 Calvert now. Mohawk with the football. And last I knew, it was 14-14 Colonel Crawford and River tied up. Still long, down there with the injury is Tyrell. He's being stretched out.
I think they got both legs up in the air, which is unusual.
Mm-hmm.
In the meantime, on OH Report, for those able to join us there, you can see we've got the Calvert Mohawk game going on there. And Mohawk trying to make a little drive here, trying to get it up close to the 50-yard line.
That game already in the fourth quarter.
Mm-hmm.
And Tyrell seems to be in some pain, holding his head out there. And certainly not a good sign.
Yep.
No matter who it is. That's one of your defensive leaders, one of your offensive leaders, certainly a returning letter winner and an all-conference returner.
Yes, exactly. He's done a lot of good things, and obviously he's also the player who earlier blocked the punt and got the block punt in for a touchdown. So contributing not just on offensive and defense but special teams as well. And here he's kind of gimpying off to the sideline. He's got a weird kind of giddy up to him, but he is walking off under his own power, which is nice.
So out of the injury timeout, it will be Galion facing a second and six. 2:51 to go here in the third from Wynford. Prosser is going to send two wide to the left. Ivy going to join him in the backfield on his left hip. Tight end to the right side. Prosser has it, gives. Here's Ivy, dive play on the left. Decent blocking, but got congested in a hurry, and a gain of three. That'll give him a good look here at third down, third and a long three.
Yeah, absolutely.
7-point ball game, 21-14 Galion. The first half, slow developing, but a extremely exciting final 2.5 minutes. We saw 21 points being scored.
Seeing on OH Report, there's Tyrell on the sideline bandaged up.
Here is Prosser on the carry. Prosser in the open field. That's got a first down, still moving up the sideline. A jump cut, but they say he steps out of bounds. And Prosser on the keeper, showing the elusiveness and extending this drive on a big third down.
And you kind of see why Prosser was chosen, to be, last year he sort of kind of pulled away and they kind of gave him this quarterback position. And that's the reason why. That's the option that he brings to the offense that is really valuable that, other quarterbacks and other players just were not. And that is, he throws a decent ball, good enough, and more importantly, they can put the ball in his hands and he can make people miss, and he's pretty quick in the open field.
He stands at the 49, has the snap, and wants to throw on first down. Still rolling. Now he's going to step up in the pocket and run with it. Throws a stiff arm at the 40, 35, and he goes out of bounds inside Wynford territory at the 35-yard line. Again, Prosser using his legs.
Yep.
Nothing downfield. Takes advantage of what the defense gives him.
And that is the one thing that I think that most teams that are going to play Galion are going to notice, that when Prosser's running that quarterback position, if you watch the film of this game, you're going to see he's going to look at that first receiver, and if he's not open, there's a good chance he's going to tuck it and run.
Mm.
That's what he's going to do. But even when he does it, he's still going to get 9 yards because, you got to get the defenders out in front of him.
Two left, one right. Here's Ivy. Ivy gets the second level. He's hit after he got the first down. Goes down just past the third, or close to the 30-yard line. Call it the 31. Skidmore in on the stop, but Ivy grinding out another first down for the Galion Tigers.
Yeah, absolutely. And again, you've got the lead if you're the Galion Tigers. So, with 1:40 on the clock in the third quarter, you're not trying to milk clock yet because, mm-hmm. You're not far enough ahead in a close game. But you're also not really in a rush. You just want to get in the right type of plays, figure out what's going to help this offense keep moving forward with first down.
Because this Wynford offense hasn't done a lot
other than
two big plays.
Mm-hmm.
Tight end to the right side, and that's going to be a false
start. Everybody
knew
the snap count except one guy, and that's the guy with the ball in his hands.
He was going on too.
Yes, he was.
So the first false start we've seen tonight goes against the Galion Tigers, and that's one that Wynford really going to want to take advantage of, because
yes.
Now it's going to be first and 15. They back it up to the 36-yard line.
Yeah, that will be the type of play that the Royals have to then say, okay, Galion has made the mistake now that we have to get this stop. Don't let the Tigers, make a big play or do something that makes them be able to get this first down here. This is their opportunity as a result of an error.
60 seconds in the third. Two guys split left. Prosser fakes it on the RPO. Prosser steps up. He is grabbed from behind, keeps his feet, and then driven to the turf at the 35-yard line. Gain of one on that play. He kept it alive as long as he could, but eventually Wynford swarms him, and Prosser goes down.
Yeah, and there's the running into the widespread arms. There's the Kotalik. I mean, because, when he does that spin, a couple of really nice plays, but on the last one there, most of the time when you can do a stutter step and move away from somebody, you have enough room to get around him. With him, when he puts those arms out wide, I don't know what his wingspan is, but it's not small. So
clogs up a couple gaps.
It does. It takes away. And for smaller guys who like to move in and out, that it doesn't give you a lot of room to get around.
Prosser wants to throw, steps up briefly. Now he's going to heave it and left it short, looking for the comeback route on the far sideline. And I think if he had the opening, he was going to do the quarterback draw up the middle. He had the option to throw it, and just good pressure by Wynford there.
Yeah, no, you're right. I mean, and that it bottled up in the middle, and then when he finally pulled around the edge, I think it may have even looked like, I wasn't sure if a defender even was able to tip the ball at that line of scrimmage, just a little bit, get a little bit of.
I think he wanted a pop pass, but a great read by Evan Wright, the middle linebacker, shut that down.
Mm-hmm. So now you're looking at a third down and 11 for the Galion Tigers.
They'll have to snap it here. 4 seconds on the clock here in the third. Prosser wants to throw. Rolling left. Blocker stays in to help. Prosser steps up.
There is
flicks
that
one
pop
out
one.
There. It is loose, and it goes innocently to the turf. Rinfus on the coverage. It was intended for Landon Campbell. Great play there. That's the end of the third quarter. It's a one-score game here at Wynford. 21-14, the Galion Tigers over the Royals. The fourth quarter coming up right after this.
comeback.
He's going to send a line drive down the field. It'll be fielded on the bounce. That is Schieffer. Schieffer finds a hole at the center. Schieffer turns on the burners. Schieffer could go. He's at the 50, 45. He's got one man to beat. Schieffer with the ball in his left hand. He's going to take it to the house. Wynford opens up the second half with a kick return touchdown.
Shutting this offense down, but Coach Skidmore needs him once again. Ball inside the Wynford territory at the 31. Fourth and 11.
Almost got him to jump on a hard count there, but able to pull back. Both defensive ends for Wynford kind of popped up but did not cross. So
their kicker, Alan Carver, with a good leg. They're not going to give him a shot at a 42-yarder here.
This is a hot, that's a kick, though. I mean, remember, you got to move back to 10 yards. I mean, this is
here
even
we go.
Longer.
Prosser looking deep across the middle. It is intercepted by Ashton Warren. Ashton grabs it, gets it to the 20-yard line. Probably could have knocked it down. But either way, Wynford gets the ball back. He wasn't going to let anybody else catch that football.
Didn't want to take the chance. And I think Coach Dick is probably over there going, that's all right. It's like a short
10-yard punt.
Yeah, exactly. I didn't get much. But, again, just kind of trying to throw it over the middle and just threw up a little too high. And, again, always staring down Elijah Chafin, mm-hmm. his primary receiver. That's the guy he looks to. It's the guy he wants to try to make plays. And just threw it up a little too high. And Ashton Warren at 6'3", able to pull that one out of the air.
Here's the Royals.
Blair
will open this drive. And not a lot of space for Caden as he is knocked down for a 2-yard loss on the play. Second and 12. This might be where Coach Skidmore needs to open up the playbook a little bit.
You know, I know it ideally in his
get
mind.
Get one out of the pocket.
I'm sure he's probably like, if I can just get a couple of first downs. You know, it's a lot harder to open up the playbook when you're inside your own 20, mm-hmm. you know. But if you can get out a little bit and you get a little ground behind you, then it becomes a little bit easier to say, all right, let's do some things that are a little more interesting, a little more tricky, maybe open something.
Renfus wide left. Evans, jet motion. Ashton Warren fakes the handoff. He's going to keep it. Warren gets a block in the open field for Renfus. Here goes Ashton Warren. 50, 45, 40, 30, 20. Ashton is going to outrun everyone to the end zone. Touchdown on the quarterback keeper. And we are a field goal away from a tie ball game.
What a great play. And you know, like I said that, you know, it's sometimes tougher to do something a little tricky. There wasn't really a lot tricky. It was just kind of a fake handoff.
Just something they haven't done yet.
Yes, fake the handoff to the guy on the outside and say, okay, Warren, run with the ball. And you can see the athleticism there. The only guy who's got any shot is Gabe Ivey's trying to chase him down from the other side of the field. And I'm like, Gabe's faster than him, but he's not going to have enough real estate in front of him to be able to track him down. He needed another 50 yards before he was going to be able to catch him from where he was standing.
And what a block on the outside by James Renfus. Wide receivers blocking. That's an underappreciated aspect about that. Extra point is up. Oh, no good. Off the foot of Hunter Ralston. So we stay at a one-point game. Galion 21, Wynford 20. 10:54 to go in the ball game. We'll be right back.
Hi, I'm Josh with Scout Construction, proud sponsor of local teams and athletes. Check out your favorite local sports right here on the OH Report.
Touchdown touchdown of the feet of Ashton Warren. Ashton, just a great move in the backfield. Fooled everybody. Great blocking by James Rimfus on the backside. And Ashton outruns everyone for the touchdown.
And when you look at it, as we're looking at the replay on the OH report, it's really kind of funny because when you see it initially, you can see as it gets down towards the end, there's a couple of Galion defenders who are trying to chase him down, and you can tell they're not going to catch him. But if you look at it about, 10 yards before that, he got through the line, and the closest people to him were his linemen. Mm-hmm. There was about 2-3 linemen behind him blocking.
Great play call.
So they were able to not only get off of, knock their guy out of the way, but keep going downfield to block other people.
Roustan, short kick, going to be fielded at the 28-yard line. Near side, gets to the 35, hit hard and dropped.
That's Blair.
Caden Blair with a big hit on the return man. He's very slow to get up. A little bit of a limp there as well. It was 16 Jacob Chambers on the return.
When the extra point got missed, us being in the press box, we're able to kind of, see as we're going to look at the replay one more time and I'll explain my point. But you could see, look at all the linemen right there who are just running downfield. No, they're not fast enough to keep up with the fastest guys on the field.
But they did their job already.
They were already doing their job and they were just running now for celebration. But after the extra point was missed right above us in the press box, the Wynford coaches, you could hear them. Mm-hmm. Made me worry about the structure here. I mean, that was... they're not pleased to, lost too many close games last year.
Here's Ivy on first and 10. He's hit hard. Gained 2 on that play.
Watch on the replay here for those on OH Report if we can get this. You're going to see, watch Skidmore's hand pop out right there. Boy, he almost got that ball loose.
I mean, did just enough to slow Ivy down.
Slowed Ivy down as a result.
Call it gain of 3, second and 7. 10:25 to go in the ballgame, 21-20. Galion over Wynford. This rivalry game dates back a while. These two don't play every year, but when they do, the fans show up. Galion sends 2 to the right, and that's going to be a false start.
Yep. Frankhouse over on the right side made a break over. Wynford sort of kind of were popping a little bit, but they didn't cross the line of scrimmage. They all just kind of stood up on the hard count, and Frankhouse took off running. So
back them up 5, call it 2nd and 12.
And again, these are the types of things that I think Wynford just needs to continue to take advantage of. They just did moments ago. Galion had a mistake. They had a penalty. Then they got the stop. Now, they've given him another penalty here. And again, remember, the Galion Tigers have not scored any offensive points since the first quarter. Mm-hmm. So everything else
their
they're
second
getting
drive of the game.
Yeah, everything else has been special teams. So the defense for Wynford has been right there.
2 to the right, Prosser fakes it, slings it, far side, left it way too high for the intended receiver, incomplete.
Yep.
Looking for Chambers over there, and he needed a stepladder.
And I think part of what you're dealing with Braxton Prosser, and this is, again, he's a junior, he played a lot last year, but, he's still, as a quarterback, he's a little bit more of a thrower than he is a passer. The ball comes out with plenty of juice behind it, but it sails a little
touch.
Bit. That, he kind of just peels back and throws it as hard as he possibly can. And
on a wet night like this, you got to have your hand on.
That's
you got to
right.
have a good handle.
And that's the type of thing that still is a little bit of a work in progress with him.
Tight end and a wing left. Prosser going to reverse out, throw far side, and again overthrows his intended receiver and Elijah Chafin going for the flag route.
Yep.
That's a tough throw for anybody right there.
Yes, it is. A long distance.
It's going
to
be fourth
throw.
And long.
But again, Chafin is the primary guy he always looks to. And the nice thing about it that Wynford has is, Chafin's, 6'1", 170 pounds, good athlete. And what Winford's doing is they're basically kind of shadowing over the top of him with Warren, who, as a 6'3 safety, can kind of sit in the middle in a ball that's a little bit high. He can play after it, knock it down, things like that.
Royals try to come after that one, and what a boomer of a punt.
Oh.
Blair's going to pick it up at the 3 and be dropped at the 4.
Yep.
Goodness.
It was not going to drop into the end zone. I think he was hoping when it went over his head that it might slip into the end zone, but it did not, So that was unfortunate that it just kind of, it just for Wynford, it died at about that 3-yard line. And Blair was like, well, I may as well try to pick it up and get something back and, not able to do it, not enough momentum. Now they got a lot of ground in front of them.
An absolute booming punt. Buries him back at the four-yard line. Actually, they'll say the three. So first and 10 with 97 yards in front of them, 9:39 on the clock.
We'll see what Wynford can come up with. Straight up the head right there, no surprise.
Not a lot of running room
not
for
a lot of surprise,
Blair.
Though. As much as, you know, look, we've really enjoyed seeing when Wynford has thrown some different things in. Here you almost need to just do a power run up the middle just to give yourself space. You don't want that end zone right behind you, because if you even try to do a sweep, if you get hit in the backfield on a play like that when you're so close to the end zone, you're potentially getting a safety. So give yourself a few yards, get away from that end zone, and then you can maybe look at doing something else.
A little bit of a bumper behind you.
Yep.
Nearing 9 minutes to go in the ballgame. Still a one-point lead for the Galion Tigers. Ashton Warren under center. One wide receiver right. Warren's going to give. Ball carry moving right side. That's Evans. Evans gets to the 10-yard line. And a nice job creating a little bit of space there by Anthony Evans.
Yeah, I would have loved Anthony was trying to kind of do a stutter step like he was going to come back inside. And, I think he was hoping that the defender over here, number one, Chafin, was going to just totally bite on it. But I think he should have just sprinted for it. I think he should have just made a gun for it. Chafin not fooled enough. And now we're looking at a third down. Good run, but may have been closer to that first down marker.
Third and two. Ashton under center, two to the right. Going to spin, give. Back moving straight ahead, driving for the first down. It looks like he's got enough.
I think he's going to get it.
Got the 13.
If they give him a bad spot, that's the only thing that'll work against him. But it might be a
measuring
moment.
It was Blair, the bigger of the two ball carriers.
Yep.
And officials haven't signaled anything yet. The white hat giving it a look.
Yeah, you might want to bring out the. Yeah,
that's what he's going to do. Official timeout. We'll stop the clock with 8:49.
While they do that, I want to remind everybody that after our game, we'll be picking our player of the game, being brought to you by the Lewis Family McDonald's of both Bucyrus and Galion. And the winners for both Galion and Wynford will get themselves a gift certificate from McDonald's of Bucyrus and Galion. And again, the Lewis Family McDonald's, if you check it out, they're all over the place throughout North Central Ohio. So we definitely appreciate them giving away that award. And they're going to bring out that measuring stick, Josh. We'll see what we got.
Oh, they got it by a long shot.
You can put a better ball in front of that.
Two ball lengths. Wynford gets the first down. Mm-hmm. Keeps the drive alive.
Yep. Good run right there. Those are good quality runs. Got them away from that goal line. Mm-hmm. I mean, that's what they really needed.
Little breath of fresh air. Mm-hmm. Cool night here at Wynford. The wind has died down a little bit. Still blowing cross. Here's Rinfus going to split wide to the left. Evans, Blair in the backfield with Ashton Warren under center. Warren has the snap, turns, gives to Blair. Blair trying to bounce it off tackle to the left, not a lot of space. Blair got to the 14, maybe a gain of a yard.
Yeah, I don't even know if
he got
that.
No, I don't think he got it.
I think he may have even lost a half a yard in terms of where they placed that ball. So.
Clock rolling. We're at 8:20 in the ball game. Stay tuned after. We got the Ken Standing Seam post-game show brought to you by Ken and Matt Studer at Ken Standing Seam. And then, of course, it's Davey Jones in a special edition of the Thursday Night Phone Board. Rinfus wide to the right on second and 10. Warren again with the wing tee behind him. Motion man left to right. Warren spins, fakes the handoff. Ashton again with an opening. Ashton tripped up by an arm tackle. But he is going to have enough for the first down to the 25-yard line. Once again, Ashton Warren showing that he can do more than just sling it.
Chafin saving once again with the ankle tackle. Because watch, if you're watching on the replay, watch, he was able to slip through. And I'm telling you right now, if he gets away from that, he's going to break a little left. There's no Galion defenders over there. He's going to have a big run right there if that's not that ankle tackle.
They'll spread it out a little bit. Two wide receivers to the right. Now they'll motion Blair to the slot. Warren wants to throw. Boot pass right side. Now Warren's going to tuck it and go. Warren at the 30, 35, pushed out of bounds, just short of the 40-yard line. And Ashton Warren, that was just a clear out.
Yep.
He was going to run that thing the
Absolutely.
Whole time. They just vacated the area. Ashton Warren using his feet once again for another first down. 7:22 to go in the ballgame. Wynford trying to fight back.
Yeah, you
trailing 21-20.
You can see it on the replay. Warren's kind of running with the ball like he's going to pass it, and then he tucks it, and he's still on that rollout. The moment that ball gets tucked, it's a run. Like they're not going to pick it back out and try to throw it. So you're absolutely right. That was intended run the entire way, no question about it.
First and 10.
They got to hurry it up here.
Warren under center. He's going to give to the fullback. That Ooh. Is Anthony Evans. And yeah. Evans, with his head down, he is clipped and tripped up after a gain of 6. But a good head of steam gets him a hard-fought 6.
I like every once in a while when they do that, when they move Evans in. Evans is just a little bit faster than Blair. Blair's stronger, tougher to bring down because he's got that low center of gravity. But Evans explodes faster, and especially in those quick hitters up the middle. Every once in a while when you throw that at defensive linemen who are used to sort of it coming at them a little slower, it surprises them. And you can see it there, 6 yards.
Second and 4, 6:45 to go. Two backs in the backfield. Fake toss. Here's Ashton using his legs again, trying to find a seam up the middle. Nowhere to go.
Yeah, they were ready for it.
Defensive tackles all over that play. That was actually the end to finish it off. Frankhouse also in there, 21, Hunter Menard.
But I do think that that's the type of thing that they can now do, sort of misdirect a little bit, where they can have Warren sort of, the next time he does give the pitch, he can turn his body and turn like he's running inside to keep those linebackers kind of frozen a mm-hmm. little bit. This play has worked for him. He's got almost 100 yards rushing now in this game as a result. So now work it in reverse. Before it was the fake pitch opened up the running lane. Well, now the running lane in the middle can open up the pitch.
Here's 3rd and 4. Here comes Blair. Evans. And Evans, the
Not
defensive end, stayed home nicely, did his job, and able to bring Evans down, no gain, and here's a big 4th down.
Yeah, and with 5:40 on the clock, I would assume Coach Skidmore is going to play the punting game here, because remember, they're down 1 point. Even if somehow Galion puts together a great drive here, they still are going to have to. They can still get the ball back and try to score again. I mean, at this point in time, a 4th down and 4, you're in your own territory. You don't want to make it too easy on the Tigers, but the special teams have got to come up big here.
Coach Skidmore sends the punt team out. Blair, he's got to hurry. High snap, Blair. He's going to fake it and throw. No, he's going to get hit and dropped in the backfield. Fake punt does not go the way of the Wynford Royals. Blair gets knocked down at the 35-yard line, and he had very little protection.
No, I mean, basically none. It was,
Galion was playing the fake.
Yeah, there were still guys trying to kind of, get into position. A lot of guys came in late.
Nobody had even turned their head yet on the top of their route.
Yeah, and it was Hunter Minyard who came barreling through. Like, he basically came through unblocked. And, he was like, all right, well, if you punt it, I'm going to block it. If you don't, I'm going after you.
And the high snap certainly didn't help.
Yeah, the whole play just got busted up. And, again, the special teams falls apart here for the Wynford Royals.
Wynford and Skidmore going to ask their defense to step up yet again. 1st and 10 for the Galion Tigers. Ball at the Royal 35. Prosser spins, gives to the back, and he's able to get to the 30. A gain of 5 on that play. And that was Gabe Ivey again.
Yep. Getting a little 5-yard pickup right there. Ivey over 100 yards in the game. Just kind of grinding away at it. I mean, again, he's had 142-yard run. But other than that, I mean, that's his 21st carry.
It's been a tough
carry.
Second half for him.
He's got 21 carries now for 109 yards. Take out the 42-yarder, you're looking at a guy who's getting 3 yards a carry, who gained 1,500 yards and was averaging over 7 yards a carry a year ago.
This Royal defense has done excellent, but they need to make a play, and they do. Getting
Evan
in the backfield,
Wright.
Evan Wright just blew up his blocker and made a stop on Gabe Ivey for a loss of 2.
Yeah, Ivy's going to end up going afterwards and be like, guys, you're killing me here. Now, he just cut through a hole. Like,
he read
middle
that
linebacker,
perfectly.
And he was just reading the play. He knew exactly where it was going, and he was on it.
Update from Calvert and Mohawk. 14-12, the Calvert Senecas over the Warriors. And it is under a minute to play in that one from Sycamore. Calvert with the football. Mohawk needs a big defensive stand. 21-14 also from Colonel Crawford. They are beating River.
Pop
pass
play.
Over the middle,
and
it is tipped incomplete. His man was wide open. Landon Campbell slipped away, but the pop pass falls incomplete, and it'll be now 4th and 7.
Oh, my goodness. They had him on the play. You know, Blair just got caught up looking at the fake run, and he let the line or the tight end.
It was free release for Campbell. Nobody even chucked him off the
exactly.
line.
Exactly. Campbell. He just let Campbell get behind him, and, you know, Prosser just let him a little bit too much. Tell you what, that Mohawk and Calvert game, coming down to it, Mohawk went down 2 points, but they're getting pretty close to Calvert's end zone.
They're in the red zone. Prosser in the gun. He's got a lead blocker. Prosser going to run for
space.
It. He's got fourth down, and he's hit and tripped
good
up.
Play.
A gain of 3, but they kept him short of the first down. Ashton Warren, James Rinfus, they've connected all night offensively, and the tag team does it on the defensive side that time.
I love the way they played that. I thought initially, when you watch this on the replay, he's got space right there. Look at a lot of run. But sure enough, there was the block that was missed. Rinfus blew up the lead blocker, gets him out of the way. Now you got two defenders there to guard just that one quarterback and try to get him down. And even though Prosser is quite shifty, those two guys, because of their speed, their ability to move as well, just cut down every possible angle. Couldn't get anything, and Wynford gets the ball back. Now they just got to get some movement with 3:37 on the clock.
He had Ivy as the lead blocker, and he just didn't follow through on his block. Here's 1st and 10 for the Royals, trying to stretch it out. Anthony Evans throws a stiff arm, but trailing him and making the play, was Ivy. Or no, excuse me.
I think it was
Tyrell.
Yeah. He's playing well, especially on that defensive end.
Gain of 2. There. Call it like 3 yards, 2nd and 7. Clock is moving, though. 2:12 to play in the ball game.
Tell you what, this is, you know, with 3:08 on the clock, I know that Winford's game, they're not really built to play from behind, but I think they need to pick it up. Mm-hmm. They don't have a real, like,
a little bit of sense of urgency.
Yeah,
here.
Like, their offense, despite the big throws they've had, is not really super high power.
They're going to throw it here. Warren pressured and sacked in the backfield.
Yeah.
Splitting right through the block was Tyrell again. Yep. What a play and what a game he's had.
He is playing super well on the defensive end. And again, remember, he has the block punt return as well. So got that one for the touchdown. I think he's been huge tonight. And that play is as big a play as that you can possibly get.
Evans was supposed to pick him up, and he just didn't do a good enough job.
And Coach Skidmore kind of walking out on the field. Like, see, there's still no urgency here.
They got a few timeouts.
I know they do. And they're looking at 3rd down. You got to even think. I mean, they just burnt a minute off the clock.
Yeah.
And
now they're going to take a timeout.
Call a timeout. Just unfortunately some clock management
issues. I know you don't want to leave Galion with any time, but you still have to get in the end zone. So Skidmore takes a timeout. 2:09 to play, 21-20. And it is an update from Mohawk and Calvert. Mohawk has scored a touchdown. I believe they celebrated.
But now they're walking back. So is that no? And there's no.
We'll keep
point
you updated
on
out of this timeout. We'll be right back on WQEL and the OH Report. What's been a thrilling week number one, and it's only Thursday. We got another one tomorrow.
<No. laughs> I'm gonna sleep well tonight. You know,
21-20, Galion over Wynford, but the Royals have the football. It is 3rd and long. Ashton Warren steps up, slips in the backfield, and it's gonna be intercepted in the center of the field. He wanted to throw it. The pocket started to collapse, and in that muddy section out there, this is just game number one on this field, but it is already muddy down there at the 15-yard line, and Ashton just slipped and goes down.
Yep. Hunter Minyard ends up reaching out and pulling it. And again, he was just pulling back. He lost his footing. You know, he was backing up, and as he went to go stop, he started falling down, and he knew, I'm going to fall, and this is going to be a 15-yard loss. So I'm going to throw this thing up in the air or at least attempt to. Maybe somebody can come down with it. Unfortunately, the person that did was a Galion Tiger. So with 2:04 left, you know, Winford's got to figure out a quick three and out here, burn some timeouts, and hope for the best.
That's if you're a Winford fan, you still probably have a bad taste in your mouth from last year.
Yep.
How many one-point, one-score losses, trailing 21-20 here with 2:04. Prosser has it. He's just going to go right up the middle. Prosser hit from behind. Ooh, almost could have fumbled that football. A big hit, but a timeout taken immediately by Coach Skidmore. Stops it with a minute 58. We'll go ahead and take another timeout. You're listening to the final 2 minutes here from Wynford.
Hi, I'm Josh with Scout Construction, proud sponsor of local teams and athletes. Check out your favorite local sports right here on the OH Report.
It'll be Buckeye Central and Crestline. Jared Moore and Tim Byrie will have the coverage of that, and OH Report will be on that game
yes,
as well.
Yes, absolutely. So, you know, feel free to watch along for those who can't make it to any of the games. But, again, this game here, you know, it's kind of interesting. I always find this kind of a bizarre thought process, but with 1:58 left on the clock, there is the other option. It's a risky one because you're down by a point. You let them score. And if they kick the field goal, okay, you're down
then
eight.
Then you got to go by.
But then, I mean, I don't know. I mean, I wouldn't probably do it.
That's a false start.
But there's a false start right there.
Hard count by the Galion Tigers, and they get them to jump or force their own guy to jump.
Yep.
So that's going to back them up five and make a second and nine, second and 14.
And, again, I wouldn't make that play based on where the ball was at. If it was probably inside the 10, I might be thinking differently. But, you know, being at the 32-yard line, you know, I'd kind of just, you know, rely on this defense that has played so well for you here today to hopefully get that stop. But I think the offensive coordinators have got to get in there and start dialing up something a little interesting because, you know, the clock is not going to be there in their favor when they get back on the field offensively.
Still a minute 58. Second and 14 for the Galion Tigers. Two to the left, two to the right. Ivy switches side, or no, excuse me, that's Frankhouse. We'll switch sides on Prosser. Prosser's going to run with it. Prosser trying to stretch it out right side. Cuts it upfield, hit and dropped inside the 30, down at the 26-yard line.
Pretty good run, though. I mean,
gain of about six.
Yep. Again, it's going to make it about, you know, third down, about 9-10 yards. Another timeout there, though, by Wynford.
That's their final timeout. So stops it with a minute 51. They need to stop here on third down. And if you're Coach Dick and the guy in Tiger, you're probably going to run this football.
Yeah.
You're not going to try and throw it and the play only lasts 3 seconds and then don't burn that clock. You got to put faith in your defense here. Go ahead and run it. Burn a bunch more time because Wynford can't stop it.
If I'm in Coach Dick's shoes, I mean, and again, I'm not, and there's a reason for that. But you know what? I think you're exactly right. I think that you're running a play here that looks to burn more clock, and then you're going to eat this thing down as much as you possibly can. On fourth down, remember, you are in Wynford territory here. I go for it on fourth down. I think because unless they get a big run here, they're still too far away to kick a field goal, despite the fact that Carver's got a heck of a leg. This would be a mammoth boot. But I think that I try to go for it and give Prosser sort of kind of rollout. You pass if you see a guy open, or you run if there it's not there.
And you never force it.
But I wouldn't give him the option now because if he throws it and you, then you can't. You know, the clock doesn't run.
Third and 10, they'll keep it on the ground. Ivy trying to stretch it out left side, hit hard. Great tackle by Rinfus. There's the speed again by James, as Ivy. You know, a lot of guys wouldn't be able to catch him to the corner, but Rinfus able to close the distance and shut it down. Clock moving, though. We're at a minute 33. It'll be fourth and six.
And I like the play call in a lot of ways because, you see, by taking it to the left side, now they can run just what I was talking about with Prosser, going right side. That's his strong side
toward
throw.
Their sideline.
Yes, exactly. It'd be strong side, right side. It's going to be an easier throw for him. And, again, but if he doesn't see it, tuck it and run. See if you can get 6-7. And, you know, they need about 6.5 looking at it in terms of that first down. But, you know, there's some options, and now they're going to take this thing down and they're going to call a timeout themselves and figure it out, and there it is. Timeout for Galion.
Stops the clock with 61 seconds. Timeout, Galion. We'll take one as well. You're listening to WQEL and watching online on the OH Report.
Hi, I'm Josh with Scout Construction, proud sponsor of local teams and athletes. Check out your favorite local sports right here on the OH Report.
Here in the Wynford Royals, Galion clinging to that 21-20 advantage. They have the football facing a third and 6.5.
Yeah, when, you know, we came out here for a good game. It was raining. We were like, oh, it's going to be ugly. The weather cleared out, and we've had a great, great night of football. Way to start the season. Big fourth down. Here we go.
Here's the ball game. Galion sends two to the left, one to the right. Frankhouse in the gun.
Another
with
timeout
Prosser.
By Galion. Yep.
And yes.
Coach Dick's going to call another timeout.
Can't take him with you, so we'll talk it over again. Didn't like the front maybe that Wynford came out in.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe looking for a more favorable matchup, but.
Looking at it, it actually seemed like what they did is they flooded most of the two receivers to the short side, left mm-hmm. side of the field, and put only one on the right side of the field, hoping that that would open up more space. It was maybe thinking exactly the thought process I was. In terms of the play call, but Wynford did not shift defenders over to that side. They basically were like, all right, well, that's fine. We're still going to keep two guys on the edge here. In case you try to run around, we're going to be ready for it.
Yeah, certainly you got to keep Prosser's legs in check here.
Mm-hmm.
You want to make him beat you, not let him beat you.
Right.
Here we go, fourth and six. Doubles formation, Prosser in the gun. He's got Frankhouse on his right hip. Wynford bringing a little pressure. Lob over the middle, wide open. They never checked on the tight end. That was the same play they almost had for a score earlier. And it is into the end zone, a touchdown for Landon Campbell.
Landon Campbell just got away from the defense. Once again, it was the same thing that we saw earlier where unfortunately, the pop pass then just got a little out of his reach. That time it didn't. Prosser rolls out. Defense comes out expecting him to maybe try to scramble with it, and they left him wide open. It made it in very easy, just a lob throw that
free release
he was
off
able
the line
to get for the touchdown.
The safety was late to get over. Easy pitch and catch. On to attempt the extra point, Alan Carver to make it an 8-point game. Carver lines it up. Ivy will hold, snap is back, hold is down, kick is up. It's a low liner, and he snuck it through. So it is an 8-point game. Wynford will have 55 seconds to get down the field, get in the end zone, and get the 2-point conversion. Week number one, couldn't ask for anything better. Final drive of the ball game when we come back.
Hi, I'm Josh with Scout Construction, proud sponsor of local teams and athletes. Check out your favorite local sports right here on the OH Report.
Watch the big play of Wynford, and that's what they've had tonight, was big plays.
Will they be
– can't lose focus.
Have they lost sight of the fact of what happened to them in the first half? Don't let James Rinfus get behind them. that's what happened to them in the first. It was very simple, but, you know. And obviously they're going to, you know, show this little pooch formation, you know, this bunch, but there's no way they're doing an onside kick here. They're going to kick this thing as deep as they possibly can.
The leg on Carver. He had one block tonight, but He's done a nice job burying them deep.
Mm-hmm.
End over end. It's going to be grabbed by Blair. Fakes the handoff. Blair's going to keep it. Goes up the middle. Caden Blair gets through the initial line. Here comes Blair. Oh, what a stiff arm. Blair keeps his feet at the 40. Caden Blair goes out of bounds at the 33-yard line. Get some of that stiff arm.
Woo! All righty. And, you know, it was funny when they did the little fake handoff at the 4-yard line. I was like, well, that's just going to kind of slow the play down. But it actually really kind of did open things up. I mean, you could see it right there.
They had to respect it.
Yeah, they kind of were like, all right, well, we got to see who's got the ball. And the defense coming down did a poor job in pursuit. They took a bad angle to him. And then Cooper Kent, who was sort of wrapped up into a block a little bit, was trying to reach out with the arm. And it was like, all right, Caden Blair said, no way. Put him
Caden
on his back.
Blair with the stiff arm to Kent. Here's Ashton Warren, wants to throw it. First and 10, has a lot of time. Ashton still dialing it up over the middle. He's got Katalik open. It is deflected and incomplete. He had KJ Katalik wide open. Katalik then murked his own guy.
Well,
that was James Rinfus, I think, was the actual
Blair.
Blair, the intended receiver.
But you know what? This was the example of what we see when Warren gets pressure and what works against them. He didn't set and throw the ball. Like you said, Katalik was running free in the middle at 6'8". Just throw the ball in the general direction.
Hard to miss him.
If he can catch, you know, you got a guy there. But he sort of was leaning back, throwing against his body, and it just sort of sailed up a little bit on him.
The Royals have life. Second and 10, Warren again throwing off his back foot. One-man route. Rinfus is out there. Incomplete. The flag comes in. Rinfus able to sell it.
Yep, there's going to be 15
yards. That's going to be
a
spot foul. It's going to be at the 22-yard line-ish. And Wynford, they are alive.
Here we go. Just going to move this ball. And you can see a beautiful job.
I mean, that was a prayer by Ashton Warren.
Yep, but quite honestly, that's sort of where they're at this point in time. Throw it up. Let your guy kind of handle it. And
that's
the one-on-one.
A good call. Chafin never turned around.
Chafin just didn't turn around. And again, in high school, 15-yard penalty.
Oh, my fault. Yep.
No, that's okay.
Not a spot foul.
No, but you know what? Still, you get a 15-yarder right there. And again, you're in Galion territory, trying to put yourself in a position to minimally get a field goal attempt. You can't. You're down 8. Sorry, I forgot about the last touchdown.
29 seconds. Warren, first and 10, wants to throw again. Stay in tight. He's got Rinfus one-on-one on the outside. Hand fighting. Rinfus goes down with it. A catch at the 5.
No,
oh,
no,
it popped out late.
Oh man.
They were hand fighting the whole way.
I thought
Rinfus
he had it.
Rinfus went up for it, and it just squirted out.
I thought he had it. It got him right in the hands, and as he rolled down, it seemed like it just popped out at the end. The ball's up. We're seeing it on the replay on the OH report. It was a fight down the field, and
it
was
Brown forced it out. Gabe Ivey, coverage.
Yep, Ivey on him. And I'll say this: Rinfus did exactly what you try to tell receivers to do. It's like, look, if you do a slight push off, don't extend too far, just a little bit. Mm. It'll give you that separation you need, and you can pull something down. That's what he went for. He just couldn't hold it. It would have had him at the 3-yard line.
Second and 10. Warren has some pressure, steps up, lets it go again. He's got Rinfus again. This time he throws in a triple coverage, and it's incomplete.
Yep.
He had Katalik on the backside.
He's got to just look off. If he looks off the primary receiver, he'd see he's got some other receivers downfield who are finding some space. I mean, it's, you know, Galion's got guys all over the place, so nobody's wide open. But throwing it deep in the triple coverage is not exactly a high percentage throw, so. But with 13 seconds, now they just kind of have to take their cracks. They are going to have to get pretty far downfield. At least, you know, midway, if they can get 15, 20 yards here and then just, you know, spike it, they'll get a little bit of a timeout on the first down.
Splits wide. Wants to throw back across his body. Ashton
throw it
in
away,
trouble.
Throw it away.
Gets rid of it, and
yep,
it's incomplete.
Smart move, actually. And
Evans. He got some pushing and shoving. Ashton Warren, no official on the play. And that could have been easily a personal foul against Galion, but nobody, including the white hat, was anywhere close to it.
Yep.
He never got off Ashton Warren.
Campbell.
Here's the replay.
It was Campbell over there. Sort of
he
on top of
him. He drove Ashton into the turf. And then after the play, we weren't able to see, but
and Warren's actually talking to the
officiating. Pleading his case to the official.
He's really upset. He's like, what the heck was that all about? But I want to give some credit. Anthony Evans made a smart move right there. If he catches that ball,
it's game.
The game is going to be over because he's going to get tackled inbounds. He's going to probably lose 5 yards. He realizes this pass I can't really do anything with. I'm just going to let it drop, and let's live for fourth down here. So smart heads-up play, and this one's going to have to go way downfield.
Here's the ball game. Warren in the gun. He's got Kotalik as a lead blocker, and now officials are going to come blow it dead. Wynford doesn't have
Wynford,
a timeout.
No, Galion's
okay.
got one.
Galion will take their final timeout with 7 seconds to go. We have an 8-point lead. Wynford trying to tie this thing up. They're going to need a touchdown and a 2-point conversion. It'll be 4th and 10 when we come back. Report. It's the season opener here on Thursday night from Wynford, and what a game it's been. 28-20. Here's the final play. Wynford going to see how far Ashton Warren can heave it.
Yeah, I was going to say, stretch the arm, kid. We got to see how far you can throw it. He's got the personal protector in there for him.
Trips right. Blitz off the side. Ashton's got pressure. He's got to get rid of it. Kotalik never saw it. Heaved up in the air, and it's incomplete.
And that'll do
it. That's going to do it. Clock hits zeros here from Wynford, and Galion able to hang on in the season opener. They beat the Royals 28-20. Ken Standing Scene post-game show and the final stats when we come back.
Take a look at all the action from Friday Night Football right here in North Central Ohio with great analysis, highlights, coach interviews, and so much more every single Friday night right here on the OH Report.
He's going to send a line drive down the field. It'll be fielded on the bounce. That is Schieffer. Schieffer finds a hole at the center. Schieffer turns on the burners. Schieffer could go. He's at the 50, 45. He's got one man to beat. Schieffer with the ball in his left hand. He's going to take it to the house. Wynford opens up the second half with a kick return touchdown. We'll be right back.
comeback. Are you ready for the comeback?
I mean, certainly you had some week one mistakes, you'll call them. Some lack of focus, taking some plays off here and there. Special teams needed tweaked a little bit. But in terms of high school football and kicking off the season, that one certainly gets you ready for football.
Say whatever you will, but both of these coaches are going to have plenty to talk about with their team this week. As you know, obviously, what we saw with the Wynford Royals is they had a lot of opportunities in this game. They just couldn't seem to figure out a way to finalize it or get away from the mistakes. You know, the special teams mistakes, especially the first half, and even going into the second half, really slaughtered them here tonight. And, you know, for the Galion Tigers, you know, Coach Dick is going to look at it and say, we were lucky to walk out of here with a victory because, quite honestly, I mean, there was a couple of big plays there that we gave up big plays, sort of, you know, breakdowns defensively, and we didn't play our best offensive game either. I mean, we got a 1,500-yard runner who was having a really hard time getting away from this Wynford defense.
Yeah, the defense played great all night for the Wynford Royals. They stepped up big, a couple stops, one in the red zone, had one turnover, and time after time after time, they stepped up the pop pass, though.
Yeah.
They were able to, the first time they tried to run it, they got away with one.
Yeah.
Tip ball, drop pass. They run it again, free release off the line of scrimmage. Nobody chucks the tight end, and he's wide open. Safety's late to get over, and, you know, you get burned. But you put yourself in that situation because of previous mistakes,
yes,
basically.
That's absolutely right. And as we look right now, let's congratulate some winners, award winners.
We are inside the Ken Stallings Team post-game show, by the way, brought to you by Ken and Matt Studer at Ken Stallings Team. Phone Matt today, 419-544-5275. That's Matt Studer, 419-544-6275. That's 6275 for the last roof you will ever need, no matter commercial, residential, new home, pole barn, whatever it is. Matt Studer at Ken Stallings Team has the roof for you.
I'll tell you right now, we've got our McDonald's players of the game, Lewis Family McDonald's, and we chose one from Wynford and from Galion, you know, being our two local schools here, and we had some guys to choose from. It wasn't the easiest. We went with James Rinfus for the Wynford Royals. Two long catches, had some nice runs out there, and defensively played quite well. So two touchdowns for James and a great game. So James Rinfus is going to be our player of the game for Wynford. And for the Galion Tigers, kind of going a little off script here for us, we're going with Lincoln Terrell. Lincoln, who a defensive player primarily, but tonight did some really special things, most notably he ends up getting Galion's second score tonight. On the block punt at the beginning of the second quarter, he ends up getting that one, bringing it in, giving Galion a 14-0 lead. So Lincoln ends up being a player that is key because later on, he's making amazing defensive plays all over the place. How many times did we call his name?
Oh, a bunch.
You know, a whole bunch of times. And then, you know, they slid him out there offensively, and he caught a couple of passes there, too, that ended up being big. So, you know, Lincoln was huge. James was huge. And both of them very worthy winners of our Lewis Family McDonald's Players of the Game. They'll both get a gift certificate from McDonald's as a result of their efforts. So congrats to them. Also want to throw out a congrats to our very first ever Chevrolet of Bucyrus save more on Route 4. First to score, and that went to Gabe Ivey. Gabe ends up getting the first points of the game, picked up a one-yard run, and as a result, ends up getting himself a $25 gift card to a local fast food restaurant and a T-shirt from Chevy of Bucyrus. So thank you to them for those that sponsorship, and also congratulations to Gabe Ivey. So Gabe,
certainly a cool deal there.
Yeah, Gabe, Lincoln, James, all doing a great job here tonight in what was an outstanding game overall.
Certainly, if you're either Wynford or Galion, a lot of good things that you're going to come from film, but certainly a lot of things you're going to fine-tune week one.
No doubt about
it. You certainly want to go in with a fine-tooth comb and nitpick a lot of the things like special teams, the breakdowns there.
Yeah.
What did we do well offensively? What looked good? You know, maybe we missed a block here.
Yes.
But certainly this game set the tone for what can be a very exciting season. A lot of teams in the area with a lot of talent returning.
Mm-hmm.
And like Tyrell, picking up right where he left off a year ago, an all conference player. James Rinfus stepping up big time. No Sam Colleen this year. They needed a number one receiver. I think they found that tonight. And there's going to be things that they will adapt to, and they're going to evolve that offense a little bit as Coach Skidmore gets a little more comfortable,
yeah.
figures out his personnel more, and that offense is a continually developing thing.
And let's be very clear. I know Wynford Royal fans, this has been really hard. Last year, they only won two games. That is not what the Royal fans are used to. They're faithful.
Five losses by one score.
But they were close in a lot of games, and we're starting here tonight, another close loss. But this Galion team's no joke.
No.
And let's be very clear here. They just served notice, Wynford did, to the teams that they're going to see later this year, especially everybody in the N10, especially on defense. This team is no joke. Because I'm telling you, Gabe Ivey is one of the best returning players in this area, and he had a heck of a time getting anywhere tonight on this team. I mean, he had one
really physical
good
up front.
Run. They were on top of things. They tackled well. They made Galion make mistakes. The question is whether or not they can keep the offense going. Yeah, they got a couple of those deep throws from Rinfus. I don't know that you can rely on getting two deep throws on kind of defensive breakdowns. Not consistently. But you know what? If they can settle in this offense a little bit and they can consistently get in the 20s on points, this Wynford Royal team is going to win a lot of games this year because there's going to be a lot of teams that are not going to be able to score 28 because I have a feeling Kyle Skidmore is also going to spend a lot of time this week on special teams because
no doubt.
That's really what cost them here tonight overall.
Final score 28-20. The Galion Tigers get the victory over the Wynford Royals. They now move to 1-0 on the season. Wynford dropping to 0-1.
Yeah, we'll do the final stats real quick now for the Galion Tigers. We'll start with them. Gabe Ivey leads the team 23 carries, 111 yards. He has the touchdown run. Braxton Prosser with 15 carries, 38 yards. Holden Hunter, the big lineman on the fake punt, 8 yards on one run. And Carson Frankhouse, 2 carries, 1 yard. So as a team, 41 carries, 158 yards, 1 touchdown. Braxton Prosser throwing the football, just 4 of 13, 43 yards. Does have the touchdown throw in there to Landon Campbell. Did throw 2 picks. Campbell, 1 catch, 24 yards. Lincoln Terrell, 2 catches for 20 yards, and Elijah Chafin, 1 catch for -1. That's the other thing about Wynford. They kept Elijah Chafin to 1 catch tonight for negative yards. That's pretty impressive.
It's a returning all-conference receiver.
Exactly. So Landon Campbell won the touchdown reception for him. But that's what I'm saying. The Galion Tigers only had 201 yards of total offense here tonight. The Royals on the flip side, Caden Blair leads them on the ground. 62 yards on – oh, sorry, I'm going to lie about that one. Let me take that one back. Ashton Warren leads them with 90 yards on 8 carries, 1 touchdown run for him. Caden Blair, it was 19 carries for 62 yards. Anthony Evans, 12 carries, 48 yards. James Rinfus, 4 carries for 7 yards. As a team, ends up with over 200 yards on the ground. I made a little miscalculation there. So looks like 207 on 43 carries. So I'll make sure that I pass that word along here as a little miscalculation. But 207 on the ground for the Wynford Royals. Passing the football, Ashton Warren goes 4 of 13, 138 yards passing, 2 touchdowns, 1 pick in there. James Rinfus, 2 catches for 115 yards, 2 touchdowns, both on the long ones. Anthony Evans, the other 2 catches for 23 yards. So as a team, 345 yards of offense for the Wynford Royals here tonight. So, again,
and how many
for Wynford,
times did you have that last year?
That's
not
what I mean.
Lot.
So for the Wynford Royals, they ended up with over 150 more yards or almost 150 more yards of offense than Galion did. But the special teams did a minute.
Yep. Special teams, it's three aspects to the game, and that's one thing that Coach Skidmore will work on this week. Stay tuned. Davy Jones coming up in the Friday, or excuse me, a special edition of the Thursday night phone board right here on WQEL. Call up Davy, anything in the wide, wide world of sports you want to talk about. Buckeye football right around the corner. Browns football, they were playing tonight against the Eagles. Guardians in a big series, closing out. They just finished up against the Reds. I think they're playing, I'd have to look that up right now. The Guards are playing the Tigers right now, yes. So stay tuned. WQEL will have that all weekend long. And, of course, coming up tomorrow night, Northmore at Upper. Jeff and I will be back in the booth. Pre-game right about 6:45. Kickoff at 7 o'clock right here on WQEL. Big thank you to everybody here at Wynford High School, to John Kreider back at Station Control, and, of course, to all of you listeners out there. Without you, this wouldn't be possible. So for Jeff Roberts, and I'm Josh Stallings saying good night and get home safe, everybody.
Are you ready for the comeback?
Take a look at all the action from Friday Night Football right here in North Central Ohio with great analysis, highlights, coach interviews, and so much more every single Friday night right here on the OH Report.
He's going to send a line drive down the field. It'll be fielded on the bounce. That is Schieffer. Schieffer finds a hole at the center. Schieffer turns on the burners. Schieffer could go. He's at the 50, 45. He's got one man to beat. Schieffer with the ball in his left hand. He's going to take it to the house. Wynford opens up the second half with a kick return touchdown.
Back here with our MVP brought to you by North Central State College. And it is a coach tonight, Matt Dick, joining me of the victorious Galion Tigers. And opening night, it's got to be like a little bit of a relief always when you come out with the dub, Matt. So just give me your overall perspective from this evening and what you thought about your guys' performance.
Yeah, I thought our kids hung tough. You know, hats off to Wynford. They're a very physical football team. They're going to do well in their league. They're going to have a good season this year. I was really impressed with how physical they were. But on the same note, we found a way to hang tough and hit a little play there at the end. Braxton landed Campbell. And, you know, that takes a lot of guts by those kids. They made a heck of a play.
You guys did a little bit of everything tonight. You had the block kick that ended up going for a touchdown. You make some big defensive efforts. You get the big touchdown throw at the end. So it truly felt like this was an overall team collective effort.
Yeah, absolutely. I think defense played great all night, gave away two big passes. Special teams, we had some awesome coverage on punt and kickoff. We had a blocked punt, so some really cool stuff happening. And a punt return, so some big stuff on special teams. We put a lot of time into that. Coach Almer, Coach Ross knew a great job with special teams, and that time paid off tonight. And I think it probably was the difference in the game because Wynford played a tough football game tonight.
You've been around this program now for a while. You had an opportunity to put your stamp on it, your identity, coach. In what ways do you feel like you've gotten better at your job heading into this season?
You know, trying to highlight our kids' skills. Gabe Ivey, we run buck sweep and power with him. He's a very special running back. And then we mix in ways to get our tight ends the ball, and I think that's really a strength of our team offensively, and we do a great job of that. On the flip side of that, defensively, we run really multiple up front, and that allows us to get a lot of different people in and a lot of different people in different places and really highlight their skills. And I think Coach Ross did a great job tonight of really throwing Winford's run game off.
Then give me your thoughts on playing Thursday night. You're one of only a couple of games going on in the entire state. Why schedule this, and what do you like about it?
Yeah, I mean, I was hoping it'd be a nice night and we get a couple more fans out. But it ended up being, you know, a real tough challenge, to be honest with you. It really changes your scrimmage schedules and all those things. It's the first day of school today. So it's a lot of work, but it's a fun experience. I think it's something our kids are going to remember for a long time.
Well, congratulations on a big win, Matt. If you want to look right up into that camera and give a shout out to anybody tonight. Now's your chance.
No shout outs. Just glad we got a win. Thank you.
All right, Matt Dick, head coach for the Galion Tigers, a winner. And we're all winners tonight because we got Thursday Night Football. That's right. It's back here in the Buckeye State and plenty more action coming up tomorrow night on Friday. But we're going to go ahead and close things out here from Wynford. Matt, thank you for the time as always, brother. Let you get into the locker room and talk to your boys. If you tune in on the OH Report, we're going to have
five live games for you guys. I'm going to be over at Clear Fork Lucas. Very much looking forward to that one. I know that we're going to be all over the place. Plenty of action for you. A couple of highlights coming up too. And you cannot forget about the Friday night picks game. We got a little bit different format coming up tomorrow night. It's going to be all the same highlights, analysis, and the guys that you like seeing. But we're going to get some coaches involved a little bit more. And we're going to switch things up on you guys. So I think it's definitely worth tuning in 11:30 tomorrow night. Got to thank all of our staff here tonight. Brandon Powell helping me run camera up top. Adam Thompson, our director and producer tonight. And always cool to tag team with WQEL. Josh Stallings always does a phenomenal job. Love working with those guys. And we're going to be partnering with them and WBCO throughout the entire course of the season. But for now, for tonight, from Wynford for Thursday night, we're going to say so long. See you again tomorrow.